Already, why can't just it work? Why can't anything I love just work? Hey everybody, you might want to make your way over to Twitch. Yeah, making your way over to Twitch might be super necessary. Yeah, I see. I don't know what's going on. I opened up Streamlabs OBS and just the YouTube chat is not showing up and I don't know why. I can stop the stream and beg and hope that that fixes it. Maybe. Yes, Torgo, we were both muted. I'm reading the chat. I'm reading YouTube chat. I see that people are here. One Hypnotic, thank you for the follow. Sinestro, thank you for the sub. Thank you, Torgo, for the commercial donations. Thank you, Sinestro. Thank you, Mr. Sketches. Thank you, Pig. But, oh my God. Ah, One Hypnotic. Yes, you're here. Yeah, if you want to see your magical, beautiful words on the screen tonight, you're probably going to have to head over to twitch.tv/PuppetJared. I wish I could fix it. I'm at a loss. I'm at a loss. I would have to just stop everything. Oh, look at all these nice new people coming in on the Twitch, just showing off their cool words. Farstar posting crabs, apparently. Z-Man, thank you for the sub. Oh, and now we got a hype train coming. Great. Oh, God. Why? I guess you could say I'm in a real crabby mood. I was actually in such a good mood right before this thing is giving me a giant headache. This is gonna be the rest of the night, is me just telling YouTube chat I'm so sorry. I saw the PNG asset and I liked it and thought it was silly. I can change it. Obviously, I have powers beyond powers. Like, there's so many different Jareds I can be. I could be spooky Jared, classy Jared. Where's a good classic? Where's a good one? I could be. Oh ho ho! Halloween's over and now I'm here! Santa Jared! That's a great one. That's a classic. Where's like Gross Pecs Jared? I worked hard on Gross Pecs Jared. Thank you for all the follows. Thank you, everybody. What? Ah, there I am. Here we go. Hi, how's it going? It's me, successful, muscular Jared. I love owning things and, house rental ship? I don't know what successful people live like. I don't know. All right. You know what? This feels weird. I'm going to go back to normal Jared. Oh, man. If this is your first time in the dumpster, if this is your introductory rodeo, let me tell you, things are way more functional. Things are usually way more working and not broken. I mean, they're usually a little broken, but not like this broken. This is like month one broken happening right now. Oh no, the cartoons. Okay, all right, here's how it goes. Here's how it goes. Every week, we sit down and watch a series of weird, bizarre, and most importantly, copyright derelict cartoons from the 80s, 90s, and 2000s. And in between those cartoons, we watch your commercial requests, which to submit it, all you got to do is donate $2 or more via the link that shows up in the description and or through Nightbot. And that's our tally. And between that, we just have ourselves a grand old laugh. Iron Lung says, do we have to make our own cartoons next week? God, I hope not. Although, I will say, I am still extremely tempted to do a Flash cartoon. Like, just oops all 2000s internet Flash cartoons. It would be a pain in the ass to curate, and like 95% of the jokes would be horrifically dated, but part of me still wants that dream to be a reality.
Enjoy your Zoa.
But you know, we, it's, yeah, now I see people in the YouTube chat. You've just resigned yourselves to be the secret chat, the underground chat, the lost chat hanging out on YouTube. Should I just like put up a thing? Can I do that? Can I just like, do I have a plugin where I can just place text on screen? Oh no, there's too much to deal with. I'm juggling too much. Man, I'm really off my game today. I mean, I'm not. I'm confident. I'm strong. I'm powerful. I'm a new media darling.
Enjoy your Zoa.
Based Willie, in reference to my 2000s Flash cartoons. Yeah, everybody is telling me the jokes. Like, it's literally all problematic shit. That is the problem. Pippa says, yes, I'm tour ready. That is, oh man. Oh, I'm very excited.
Enjoy your Zoa.
I wrote a joke today for the tour about Princess Zelda's hot stepmom, Judy. I'm very excited about sharing that one. Siniscro says 70% of Dr. Tran still holds up. Yeah, and that's pretty good. That's pretty good by Flash cartoons. All right. Yeah. Ooh. I am also excited to go to California and do the show. Happy Tree Friends, I think. I mean, the thing with Happy Tree Friends is that the jokes are like, you know, they don't get racial or sexist with it, but the joke of haha, cute thing is violent gets so old so fast. Homestar's so good. It feels like it's its own thing. Like, Homestar exists outside of, even though it, I mean, obviously, technologically, chronologically, it's all part of the Flash wave. Homestar Runner is its own beautiful thing, in my eyes, at least. Homestar is near perfect. Homestar Runner is the Weird Al Yankovic biopic of internet sites. By the way, if you haven't watched the Weird Al biopic thing yet, oh my God, it might be my favorite comedy of like the past couple of years. It's like Barb and Star and the Weird Al biopic. As someone, I don't know if it works the same if you aren't familiar with Weird Al Yankovic, but like, God, as someone that had every single one of those records, it really just like every joke landed for me. I loved it to bits.
Enjoy
and the yourself. Fact that it's available only on the Roku channel and the whole experience just was amazing. 10 out of 10 on the Weird Al documentary. Centurion Batman, thank you for the bits. Deadneck, thank you for the donos. Vince Omni, Gingerbeard, Sinestro. God. All right. I guess we got to get started.
Enjoy your Zola.
Once again, it is with a heavy heart that I must say that I fucked up and can't get the YouTube stream chat to appear on screen. I wish, Lord, I wish it weren't so. But if you make your way over to twitch.tv/YouTube, you can still see your beautiful words in the chat box. But God, okay, 20 minutes and we haven't started the first cartoon yet. I'm sorry. It's been a real stumble bumble kind of night. I appreciate everybody's support. I'm glad you're all here. And goddamn, here we go. Here we go. Let's get to the TV room. As is our new tradition, you know we gotta start. We gotta start with the goddamn Galaxy Rangers. And so this one is no exception. What strange new powers will Shane Goose Guzman, Mr. Stronger Than Goku himself, appear with today?
Enjoy your Zoa.
Will Buzzwing... Hey, Sote, thank you so much for the $5 dono. I'm high on hard Mountain Dews? What? That exists? Will we get valuable, important backstory relating to the wife in the cupboard? Will we revisit the cupboard wife? We've been every week we've been asking ourselves, is the wife still in the cupboard? How is she doing in the cupboard? Has anyone bothered to check on her? And hopefully, maybe, just maybe, we'll be able to find out. Well, 5% alcohol and sugar-free? Diet, hard diet dew? That might be my perfect beverage. That might be my, wait, oh wait, now people are discussing the merits of the dew. Now I'm not so sure. Only one thing, I'm just going to have to drink a case of it myself. And, you know, whatever happens, happens. Okay, all right. Galaxy Rangers, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen. Hey! I love them little bitties. Give me them little bitties. Yum, yum, delicious shapes. Put them in my digital mouth. Okay, cartoon, the reason we're here. I swear I didn't forget. Let's go.
In 2086, two peaceful aliens journeyed to Earth, seeking our help. In return,
come along if you know the tune.
For our first hyper drive.
Hey, yum, 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 yum.
Mankind to open the doors to the stars. We have assembled a team of unique individuals to protect Earth and our allies. Courageous pioneers committed to the highest ideals of justice and dedicated to preserving law and order across the new...
I'm glad Galaxy Rangers can make your day, Vasty.
Adventures of the Galaxy Rangers.
Into this world. Enjoy yourself.
No guts, no glory.
Oh, take it as that.
Wheel, nearly now.
Ready to prove it again.
Enjoy your Zoa.
Ah, shit, the Queen's back. Oh my God, is this
happening? All outside communications are being jammed. There's something coming through on the Andorian Deep Space Link.
Greetings, Earthlings. I am the power.
The Queen of the Crown.
I invite you to witness a demonstration of my new gun. With this weapon, I will reach through the barriers of space and time and crush my enemies. Observe the primary star of Wolcab. I have placed a neutron star in orbit around it. The neutron star will draw off the bigger star's energy and feed it to my gun.
You did not have to explain the science of big gun. You genuinely did not. Maybe it'll come up later where, like, now that we know how it works, that's how they beat it, by cutting off the power source. But you really didn't need to have to explain. You could have just been like, me have big gun go boom, boom. Me do big gun times. Puppy Bear, this is The Adventures of the Galaxy Rangers, and you're in for a treat.
This intense energy will be fired through hyperspace.
Rusty, thank you for the donut. Laser piss! Goddamn.
I trust your moon is served as an adequate example of
what?
My power. Agree to my terms, or you are
They canonically blew up the moon. I love that. They, for the rest of this show, they better just have a huge stinking hole in the moon for, like, the rest of the goddamn series. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I love that. I love that. It's, in the Tick, in the 90s Tick cartoon. Right. Torgo beat me to it. Torgo, get out of my head, Torgo. Every fucking time. Every time. Piccolo did it first. That's also true, Vasty. I'm telling you, when you blow up the moon, you're in for a good time. It is like a sign of quality. It's like an innate understanding of scale and stakes. I'm so happy she blew up the moon. All of you quoting via Sonic dub. I love it.
Doomed.
What is it you want?
5,000 humans. You will send them in your Andorian ships to Tortuna, where I will take charge of them.
Fucking Tortuna again.
You are mad.
Mad enough to destroy your planet piece by piece.
The planet Wildcat.
I love her normal laugh.
Choice for the Queen's gun. It's within striking distance of the entire League of Planets. The gun is located at the center of a large crater in Wallcab's northern hemisphere. Now we'll have to try a surprise aerial assault and hope their fighter screen can be penetrated.
I have arranged for our assault group to meet up with the Wallcabian freedom fighters. It is essential that we remove the neutron star as well as the gun.
How can we possibly do that?
Our assault team will have to take control of the gun long enough to fire it once at the neutron star. That will kick it right out of the Wallcab system. A process much like your Earth game, billiards.
Is there any way we can negotiate?
I would remind you, Senator.
It's, yes, it is like playing billiards. That's right, it's just a big old galactic snooker match. Oh my God.
That the Gherkin people have been reduced to a...
The Gherkin? Wait, they mentioned the... We've had the Gherkins on before. God, there's so much deep lore. There's canon and continuity. I don't know if I can handle this. El Condor Pasa, this is The Adventures of the Galaxy Rangers. And hoo boy, I think this is going to be a weird one to come in blind on.
A bare handful of refugees by the Queen's greed for her psycho crystals. The team going in is the Series 5 Galaxy Rangers, the best we have. If anyone can pull this off, it's them.
Going on a mission. Gotta do
the... Patrol ship's closing in.
Lock in coordinates for our drop window and switch into auto. We're going in.
Rice?
Goose, get ready.
Why does he need that dumb helmet? He's never needed that dumb helmet before. Oh, solidly 80s. The most 80s. Blackbird. Thank you for the secret YouTube super chat.
Not yet.
Crown
from fighters closing from Sector 304.
Launch! Ready for planetfall.
There's Porkins.
We're going in hard. Remember the landing drills.
Yeah, wait, no, come on. Wait, where is Porkins? You can't have a segment like this without like Lieutenant Jimmy, who's like, oh boy, I can't wait to fly this mission. I believe we gotta stop those dang evils. Alien zoids. And then he just gets blasted out of the sky, and everybody's like, no, Jimmy. Wait, what?
Release your chutes now!
Hey, Gingerbeard. Oh, goddamn!
Whew! That was some ride.
We got 100 viewers. Goddamn.
Come on, let's get those jet cycles flying.
Between the secret forsaken YouTube people and the Twitch guys, how you doing?
Heading is northeast, 58 degrees, 46 seconds.
This must be the place.
Ooh. These are the freedom fighters.
Just sad Ewoks. Just like Great Depression Ewoks.
Yub nub. Things haven't been the same since silver prices plummeted. Yub nub chub chub.
Also, Gingerbeard, congratulations on having a new big ass TV that you got for your PS5. I hope you enjoy God of War Ragnarok after the stream. Huh, they do look like werewolves. Good point, Lolo Frosty.
These are the freedom fighters?
These people have suffered. Their world has been stolen.
Goose, keep watch. Doc, check for enemy signals.
Who are you, aliens?
We're the Galaxy Rangers.
Oh, the underground radio whispers your name on 1,000 worlds. My name is Burba. I was once mayor of this place.
What? Burba. Burba, the mayor of Rockhole. Like, their planet... You know, alien invasion or not, your planet sucks, Burba. Burba, you're probably a shit leader. Got to invest in infrastructure there, Burba.
Welcome to the planet Volcab, Galaxy Rangers.
Thanks. We're supposed to contact the Freedom Fighters.
You will bring down the wrath of the Queen upon what is left of us.
The gun is the cause of your troubles. If we destroy it, the Queen will leave your planet.
I will lead our allies to the underground.
Ma, there is no underground there. They've been exterminated.
No, lad. Many still live.
Look, we're going in with or without them.
I'm sorry, Soul2XL in the YouTube chat just called them the Space IRA, and he's fucking right, and I hate it. Come out, ye space black and tans! Come out and fight me like a man!
Something is following us.
Follow me.
Crown agents.
They're heading right for us. Quickly, into the tunnels.
Ah, no, Krinkle, stop.
Doc, take them out.
Watch this shot, Goose.
Damn.
I see now why the Galaxy Rangers have such a reputation.
Oh, shooting at them. Oh, we didn't think of that. Oh, we've just been like politely asking them to leave and tying their little space shoelaces together and such. Huh. Oh, turns out you can just shoot at them and their thingies explode. Fudge and Bagushka. That really tickles my potato.
Move out!
Spy fly.
Out, busted up.
What?
Holy silicon, what's that?
Ah, the Queen's Planet Crusher.
The Planet Crusher.
Evasive
action! Oh, watch out! It's their legally distinct from the Death Star big evil machine!
My 505s are just bouncing off that monster!
Yeah, you think? Oh, I tried hitting it with a toothpick and it did nothing! It's fine.
We go!
God! God damn it. God damn it. Just literally, not even, they just, what form is this? Is he supposed to be metal? What version of Guzman is this? That he can just bust through rocks and just save the girl. Guzman, perfect character. He's Silver Surfer. He has... Guzman now has the power cosmic. Metal Goose Solid. Oh, now the... He's powered himself up so much... that now his gun does more damage. He literally got +3 ranged attack bonus because he's fucking Goosemaned up. God damn it.
Good work, Goose.
Galaxy Rangers, ho!
Zack's like, technically, I'm still the leader. You may have all the powers and do things, but I really feel like that's my line. You know what? Whatever. Yes. Yes. Follow Guzman. Oh, hey, how you doing, Pippa?
How are we going to find the Freedom Fighters?
Don't worry. They'll find us.
This is a Star Wars homage episode. Every episode has a different kind of theme going for it. And you're right, this one is definitely playing with Star Wars tropes. They've done like haunted house episodes, Old West episodes, weird like psychological thriller episodes. I love that they just call it the gun. The Baby Buzzwing episode was like a Gremlins kind of like creature feature.
Well, will you take a look at the royal architecture?
Oh, The whole thing is powered by a Simon game set.
Who can she be firing at now?
The Queen has many enemies besides Earth.
The ground's crawling with crown tanks. How are we going to get across there?
Klaatu Nikto Barada.
What? Really? Also, isn't it Klaatu Barada Nikto? Why would they change that for, like, just make the reference? Also, I love Guzman. Just immediate. What? Stop. Hey, stop speaking foreign weird talk. I'm going to shoot you.
Goose, don't shoot.
The Freedom Fighters.
You ought to be more careful when you say hello.
We're cops. We're space cops. We'll shoot you in the face just for annoying us. We're fucking madmen. We're psychopaths. We have an unlimited budget and no consequences.
I'm sorry, but there is little time. This is not a safe place.
Where is on this planet?
Come, there's a hidden tunnel.
Let's get our gear.
This is the Queen! Where is the pizza I ordered?
Say what?
What?
The one with anchovies and peanut butter?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, I can't believe. Wait, what? No, Pippa, that accent was like definitely a Eddie Murphy, Hercules, Medea, like black woman voice. Yes, Gingerbeard, of course I'm rewinding. Of course, how could I? That is like the most I have to rewind clip we've ever had. All right. So they're like, all right, let's go somewhere and plan or something. And their plan was a fake pizza order from the Queen?
Gear.
This is the Queen. Where is the pizza I ordered?
Say what?
The one with anchovies and peanut butter?
Here.
Good work. Back into the Queen's target.
What was that noise? What was that pistol whip robot noise?
And peanut butter?
Here.
Good.
This, that whole segment feels like it should be a fan dub. This should feel like a group of stone Gen Zers had to like, or the I'm the Juggernaut bitch team recorded that.
Work, Doc. Break into the Queen's targeting computer from this station. The Doctor will operate. Let's go, Pathfinder. Get me access codes. All right, Tripwire. Cover Pathfinder and watch out for the security disruptor programs. Go, Tweaker. Nothing a good tweaker can't handle.
What is this? Oh.
We need to place our blast charges up there. Okay, let's move.
You have done well, Burba.
What of my family?
Well, we will see about them.
But you promised to free them.
So what?
normal laugh.
The Galaxy Rangers. I want them captured and brought here to me.
Yes, my queen.
That was a cool sound effect.
The explosives are ready. Next time this gun is fired, it'll trigger the explosives.
Okay, hear me out.
Doc just hit the neutron star with the first shot.
Trouble! Stay back!
Yeah! I love it when he fist blasts them. Ow! My breasts! Ah! Why are they so... They have never rendered her chest in any detail. But whoever was in charge of this shot is just horny as fuck. God damn. I know she's from outer space, but those girls be defying gravity, y'all. Also, god damn, what is... Okay, first of all, she just gets just immediately shot. Where did they... Did they like even make an effort to show her getting shot in like the shoulder, or did she just get like point blank just brained? Nico, I'm sorry, I didn't see him. He was slightly off camera.
Nico! Oh! No! Oh.
No way. No way that goon could take on the Goose Man. Flying body splash. Okay, what's he doing? What's he doing? Did he make himself fatter? No, come on! Come on! Flying squirrel Goose Man? Wait, come on. Also that he let out his battle, like his like, oh, you fucked up now, here we go. And he's just like a little flying, like little wingy boys. God, oh, I love this. Heard a versatile board. Now get ready for adaptable goose.
Nice of you to drop in on us.
Come on, the Crown agents got Zack and Nico.
Welcome, Galaxy Rangers.
Berber, you traitor.
I am sorry, but the Queen has my family in her dungeon.
What?
Silence! Before you two are shipped to the Psycho Crypt, I'll show you how I'll punish the Earth.
Wait.
For this defiance!
Wait. How did him betraying them alter anything? Like, they were still gonna try and stop them from blowing up the thing. They knew they were coming. They had guards. What did he do? Okay.
Prepare the gum.
Yes, my queen.
Target, Beta Mountain on Earth.
Beta Mountain.
The League of Planets will crawl before me.
And you can crawl over this.
Get them!
Shot a grenade at his Rangers. Friends.
Ho!
Oh, everybody gets to say it.
Goose, help us out.
Thank you, Shane.
The Queen set the gun to fire it.
And the award for most awkward wink in a 1980s cartoon shown on a Twitch stream is... Nico.
Thank you, Shane.
She's got Katy Perry vibes. Like she's malfunctioning.
Doc, the Queen set the gun to fire at Beta Mountain. Reset the coordinates.
Oh, great.
I love that they showed her just scurrying away.
Late. My gun will destroy their Beta Mountain.
Pathfinder, baby, where are you?
Terminator programs! Help, Doc! Help, help!
Hang on! Quick, we must return through our tunnels.
You can't escape that way. Our bombs will blow this whole place into micro dust.
To the hangar bay! We can escape in the ships there!
Come on, Doc, hurry up! The gun is going to fire in 2 minutes!
Go ahead, I'm not leaving without my programs.
What? What, you don't have a backup?
What I do for you guys?
Take that, Great Brit! Okay, we're free! Target coordinates activated!
Blow.
What are you talking about?
The charges we planted didn't go off.
Wait.
Doc, the gun is out of control.
Wait. Wait, what is happening?
Ooh, can I breathe now?
Sure. I estimate we have enough air for another 5 minutes.
What?
Is that all?
What?
Well, my friends, if we don't make it, I want you to know that I've never been prouder
what?
To be a Galaxy Ranger.
What? Wait, what? Wait. Wait, they're gonna run out of oxygen? Wait, also, I love that Nico is like comforting Gooseman. Wait, okay, hold on. Okay, that gun did shoot a massive laser into the middle of space. And like, who knows where that thing's going? Is that gonna hit their like base? I don't know. Then it explodes.
Ooh, can I breathe now?
Oh, hey, Benjamin, thank you for the super chat. Goddamn, even stuck in YouTube chat jail, which again, I'm sorry, I don't know why it doesn't work. I really wish it would. I will do everything I can to get it fixed for next time. Okay. And Modern Bard also coming in. Oh, my God. Oh, okay. Modern Bard just made a very nice, very sincere comment. He says, hey, folks, we've had fun here tonight, but with Veterans Day approaching, there's not nearly enough space to say everything. But as a vet, I know for some the war is over, but the fight in one way or another rages on. Despite that, there is hope. R.I.P. S.R.A. White. Oh, my God. Okay. I'm at a loss for words, but that those are very sincere, very nice, very needed words. And obviously Veterans Day kind of just gets forgotten a lot or pushed aside or just an excuse for a sale or a day off work. But it's never a bad time to like think about the people that are affected by war and how maybe there are things we can do to at least try and make life better for those who need it. Thank you, Modern Bard. That was very well said.
Sure. I estimate we have enough air for another 5 minutes.
Is that all?
Well, my friends, if we don't make it, I want you to know that I've never been prouder to be a Galaxy Ranger and to be part of this team. You're the best.
You got that right.
Are they all just resigning? Are they all...
Ahoy, Galaxy Ranger!
Oh, okay.
Zach, you can save the speech. That's the Space Navy frigate Comanche.
Well, how about that? Those Navy guys. They also know about turning up in the nick of time.
What? What a weird choice. What? Why would you do that? Why would you do that? Oh my God. I mean, always a big pile of surprises. Always just a giant, just clusterfuck of unknowables every episode of Galaxy Rangers. El Condor, you're right, that was a little bit dark. Oh shit! Wally super chatting from the YouTube channel. He says, it's not YouTube jail, it's super secret chat. That is a very healthy attitude. If it's not confusing, it's not Galaxy Rangers, says Farstar in the YouTube chat. And it's true. Even, I love that even their like semi-serious wartime episode where they're like struggling in the trenches with the freedom fighters and like, there's something like they were trying to say something with Burba, like betraying them because it was his family that was taken capture. El Condor, they couldn't have, this was their serious episode. They couldn't have buzzwanging it up. Mutant Lover Boy says the Navy vessel was a hypoxia hallucination before death. Nah, there's way more adventures the Galaxy Rangers are going to get up to. We got dozens more of these bad boys. I'm like dreading the day that like maybe around season 2.5, the budget just drops off a cliff and it turns out like that it's just not good anymore. But for now, I will always eagerly, as it gets closer to 7 p.m. on Thursdays, just whisper to myself, I wonder what Gooseman's going to do this week. There's only one season. There's one season, but there's a lot of goddamn episodes. Aw. All right. But, before we start the next cartoon, there's you notice this guy up here. All those donations means a lot of commercial donations, commercial requests. And this is the part of the show where we watch them. And sometimes they're exciting. Sometimes they're nostalgic. Sometimes they actually have a good point. And sometimes they're the entire trailer to a bad Resident Evil movie. Life's funny that way. Let me just get a bunch of these into the chat. Or, I'm sorry, into the queue. And we will start watching them. Thank you, everybody who's donated so far. This is always... It's like a delightful, it's kind of like content Russian roulette. I have no idea what any of these are going to be. And frankly, the tiny just pinch of terror I feel in my scrotum every video we add to the queue, not knowing what it's going to be, is just, it definitely gets the adrenals going. It definitely, adrenaline, norepinephrine, cortisol. Just all the good brain chemicals start flowing when it's commercial time. Whoa, another super chat. Kami Kazedna. Can't wait to see you and Holden in Page 7 in December. Love all the content. Ah, yay. Thank you.
Enjoy your Zoa.
Actually, this week I recorded a episode with the Page 7 crew. They brought me in as a guest host. Had a lot of fun talking about all the weird celebrity Halloween stuff and Elon Musk's continual Twitter nightmare that's been going on for the past week. And we just recorded our God of War episode. So, Mutant Lover. Oh, no, Mutant Lover Boy. Why would you mention accordion repair? Why would you mention accordion repair? Now I'm scared. Now I'm terrified. Oh, no. Oh, no. God. I don't know if I'd be able to take it. Anyway. This first one's from Mr. Sketches, who got in early with these, who says, the eggening continues.
Hi, you're really gonna fall for Morningstar Farms' new cholesterol-free egg substitute called Scramblers, because Scramblers come the way most people like, in handy two egg-size cartons, and each gives you the equivalent of two large eggs with no measuring, no leftovers. Three cartons to a package, and they taste like farm-fresh eggs. After all, cholesterol-free Scramblers come from Morningstar Farms, and that always means delicious. Scramblers, taste them, you're gonna fall for them.
One of the things I find so fascinating is Morningstar Farms is run by Seventh-day Adventists, like a fairly, I'm not going to say like medium intense Christian sect, and they literally called their brand Morningstar Farms, like Lucifer, like the devil. And I will never understand what dark machinations made them do that. Modern Bart says, speaking of Whizbrew, I don't want to hear you calling out any naked folks in the chat after claiming to be recording pantsless for the Lupin episode. I wasn't naked. I just wasn't wearing pants. That's different. It's different. Anyway, this is another Mr. Sketches donation. Coca-Cola Humpty Dumpty. And he says, thus endeth the eggening? We'll find out.
Celery, sandwiches. What we need here is... Oh, thank
you. Oh, no.
What we need here is some chips with no salt added.
Yeah.
Hors d'oeuvres, canapes, fruit kebab. What we need here are some... Oh, thank you.
1 pound ripple chips on special for $1.69.
Mystic Thurge? Whatever, thank you for the clarification, actually. The Morning Star isn't actually the devil in the Bible, it's the planet Venus. That makes a nice, that's actually, thank you. That was actually educational. You know what? For all the grossness of that Humpty Dumpty thing, I was more icked out by that guy requesting salt-free potato chips. That's gross. Also, Snapkick37 says, this stream is a lot of fun. I'm a big Whizbrew fan. First time in the chat. Welcome aboard. Welcome to the nightmare zone. You can never leave. Professor Pig donated for this one and says original honey monster advert.
I'd like to introduce you to Honey Monster.
Mummy.
Ah!
His mummy. Now, to help a honey monster through the morning, I give him breakfast, including sugar puffs and milk.
Tell him about the honey, mummy.
Pieces of natural wheat, puffed up and tasting of honey.
Honey, the taste of honey.
I kind of like this design. Nuggetron says, is that Fetterman? Yes.
Tell him about the honey, mommy.
Yes, that is future U.S. Senator John Fetterman. Magnavox Odyssey commercial. Ah, the OG. Torgo donated for this one and says, a commercial for the first ever home video game console.
Magnavox presents Odyssey, the electronic game of the future.
Odyssey easily attaches to any brand TV, black and white or color, to create a closed-circuit electronic playground.
I'm sorry. The fucking fife and piccolo music to denote the fun of video games is hilarious to me. Like, think about it. This is like, there wasn't video game marketing before this. Like this, like, you know, no Sega, no Nintendo. This is the 1970s, and this is how they're selling video games.
Future. Odyssey easily attaches to any brand TV, black and white or color, to create a closed-circuit electronic playground. Odyssey gives you all the exciting action of hockey and 11 other challenging play and learning games for the
fucking
family.
Plastic stickers you had to stick on your TV.
Odyssey.
Because it's all just squares.
Your television. Now at your Magnavox dealer. He's listed in the yellow pages.
Pong? No way, man. No way. Pong was way more advanced than that shit. 90s Garfield fruit snack commercial. Torgo donated for this one and says, "Hey, kids." I'm sure in context, I'll know what that means.
The great Garfield will not...
Single channel audio warning. There's nothing wrong with your headphones or speakers. This video has single channel audio.
I'll perform a triple somersault while eating those good-looking Garfield fruit snacks.
Garfield fruit snacks? Stinky!
Here goes.
One, two,
that clown upsets me.
Stop. Have a nice trip! Uh-oh!
Gotcha.
No!
Oh, just a dream. What? That clown's in my fruit snacks.
Now, Biggie the Clown fruit bits in marked boxes of Garfield fruit snacks. Great tasting.
And good looking!
What a weird selling point. What a weird selling point that it's, hey, don't worry. We have Binky the Clown fruit snacks. Nuggetron, you're right. The opaque ones did hit different. They did have that little je ne sais quoi of extra deliciousness compared to the translucent, more gel-like fruit snacks bits. This one is donated by Siniscro and says, I know we're running out of Dodd, so I offer to you Little John. Ooh.
I'm Super Go Man, the fairest in the land. I'm taking you to Little John.
Yes, already. I'm in. I love it. I'm about it. As a fan of half-ass song parodies, as a creator and advocate for extremely half-assed song parodies, that was beautiful.
Broken user smash, he pays you cash. So bring it in and get your cash today. He wants to buy your own jewelry. Gold, silver, platinum, even ruby. Gold's trading at 1400 an ounce. So bring it in and get your cash today.
I'm Little John. Don't mail it in.
Bring it in.
Amazing. Fantastic. Oh, that was so good. Thank you for that, Sinescro. Torgo donated for this one and says, I couldn't find a commercial for Devo 2.0, Disney's attempt at a Kidz Bop knockoff using sanitized Devo songs. So here's Devo selling Honda scooters instead. What? What? Mark Mothersbaugh would never...
How to ride a Honda scooter.
First, select shirt pant combo.
We suggest this or this. Next, select appropriate shoes. We suggest two.
Then choose a scooter that best expresses your individuality. There are many sizes and colors.
And always wear your helmet.
Hey.
Honda scooters. They're everything but ordinary.
Kit, thank you so much for the super chat. Kit Blackford says, gotta get back to work. Remember to redacted secret YouTube chat forever. Aw, that's kind of nice. I am still extremely sorry, secret YouTube chat. I'm so sorry. Torgo donated for this one and says, chess meets battleship meets Pneumatics. Huh. Have I ever heard of this? Have I ever heard of this game? Ugh. All right. Well, going rogue. I still don't know why they do this.
This is Battleboard. Your mission? Get two men to the castle wall. By strategically moving your men, one space at a time, across the battlefield. After you've each made a move, you try to search and destroy.
Oh, that's fun. That's actually
fun.
Using the
air catapult, you seek out the enemy and blow him off the board. Get your king to the front line and a captured knight will be returned. It's a tough battle and getting tougher. You each have one man at the wall. You search but can't find him. He's sure he's figured out your attack plan. He missed. And you've made it. The battle's over for now. Battleboard, a game of strategy and action from Ideal.
Huh. That A, everybody saying, oh, the pieces will get lost. Absolutely correct. 100% correct. But also, absolutely reeks of the kind of game you'd start playing. You and your friend would both get bored and you would just start trying to launch pieces. Like, they might as well call it Tiny Man Launcher, the fun toy where you launch tiny men and just have the entire game portion just be completely arbitrary. Anyway, this next one is another Torgo donation who says, with teenager comes much responsibility. And it'll, yeah, there it goes.
Proper care and feeding of a teenager. Number one rule, don't let them drink alcohol.
What?
Rule number two, never let them get into a car with a driver who has been drinking.
These are just clips from the movie.
Rule number three, never, ever, under any circumstances, allow him to take illegal drugs.
I'm sorry that their image for like smoking marijuana is a melting, screaming skeleton. Is very, it's a, come on.
To grow up a happy, healthy teenager is important. If you love them, you'll take good care of them.
If you drink, don't drive. A reminder from WVUE Channel 8.
Okay. If you insist. Okay. Corey Lenema Art donated for this one and says, never too young to learn about capitalism. I played a lot of Monopoly Junior as a kid. I mean, it was like all the fun of Monopoly, and it only took 40 minutes instead of fucking forever.
Nobody's too young to play the Monopoly game.
Yeah, there's the Monopoly Junior game for kids just like you.
It's all about a trip to the amusement park.
You get to buy and sell like Monopoly.
You can get rich.
Like Monopoly, the Monopoly Junior game. Specially designed for your kids 5 to 8.
Vasty, the same.
Enjoy the same.
It got to the point where like we hit the Monopoly board because there were too many bad memories attached to it. Like just so many just exhausted, just tired, disgusting intra-family fights because of that game. Oh, no. Oh, no. Gingerbeard donated for this one and says, can you believe we're at number 14? Almost halfway there. Oh, no. Okay. It's Kidz Bop.
You've never seen Kidz Bop like this.
Ugh. I can already tell this is a shitty year. This is a shitty year for music.
Ready! I wanna take you away.
Let's escape into it.
It's a whole new way to make this summer fun. It's the unbelievable Kids Bop 14. Today's biggest songs sung by kids for kids.
Ugh, shit.
Kids Bop 14 features special guest Sean Kingston.
Ugh.
You can hang out at kidsbop.com and see how you could be a Kids Bop star.
You can order Kids Bop 14 and receive two copies. To order two CDs of Kids Bop 14 for $18.98 plus $5.98.
Basti again.
Call the number on your screen or log on to kidsbop.com. Must be 18 or older.
Yeah. Pumpkin Spice Latte ass soundtrack. Genuinely terrible. Soulless garbage. And then, like, the Kids Bopped version of soulless garbage. It's shit toast with shit butter. Torgo donated for this and says, why, yes, I would love some pizza. Jesus Christ, what the fuck are you? Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I'm scared now.
Noble Roman's hand-tossed round pizza is made fresh as the smile on your face.
Okay. Ah!
Our dough is made from scratch and hand-tossed.
Maybe that was just a fluke. Maybe it's fine.
Want to know what goes on?
Okay.
Top?
No!
Rich sauce! Yummy, yummy toppings!
And cheese!
I'm sorry. The cheese kid was scarier than the monster. This kid has... Like, look at this fucking Children of the Corn ass, like, monster baby. The haircut, the teeth, the eyes. Oh, my God. Oh, the monster was in the house all along.
Round and round, the hand-tossed round, yay!
Dig into Noble Roman's hand-tossed round pizza. It's as fresh as the smile on your face.
I was, you know what? The monster was okay. That kid is going to haunt me. Oh my God. What? What happened? What was that? Back. All right, here we go. Mutant Lover Boy, that kid grew up to be featured on Last Podcast on the Left. Probably.
Enjoy your Zoa.
Thank you for the dono, Gingerbeard. Speaking of Gingerbeard, you donated for this one and says, shout out to my OG home in the USA, Pahonix, Arizona.
I'd like to overnight this gift to Pahonix.
Okay, FedEx can get it there first thing tomorrow. We can also professionally package it with our new pack and ship service. Pahonix, what's that?
Pahonix is the biggest city in Arizona, the capital of Arizona.
Oh.
Do you mean Phoenix?
The new FedEx Kinko's. Make it, print
that's
it,
funny. That was funny. It.
Our office is yours.
That
office.
Was a nice little piece of business. That got me. That actually got me. That was nice. Torco donate. This says Little John's. I think MediaShare is fucking up. Tell you what, Torgo, I'm just going to assume that this got eaten and that Sinestro's Little John's ad will come in later. But here we go. This one was from Torgo for Coleco Telstar and says, let's see how far technology has advanced in 4 years.
Watching the most exciting game you will ever see on your TV set. Telstar by Coleco, with three different games. Telstar Tennis, with digital scoring, variable
okay.
Scores. Telstar Hockey, each player okay. Controls a goalie plus a forward on the other
okay.
Side. Oops, a goal. And Telstar Singles Handball, a game you play yourself. Telstar
wow. Handball,
tennis, hockey. All
wow, we got Pong, shittier Pong, and even shittier Pong. All three amazing games.
Three at an exciting low price. For great family fun, hitch your TV to a Telstar by Coleco.
It's terrible. Although we have, like, it's the way that video games get exponentially better is fascinating. Because we had with the Odyssey, just squares.
Star singles handball.
Just like loose squares. But this time we have like rectangles and numbers and like different play fields. Like that's pretty good. And that rate of exponential improvement gets us from PS4 to PS5, where like we get 300,000 polygons per character to 700,000 polygons per character. And like you can barely tell the difference. But let's go back to Broken Ass Media Share and watch this Lil Jon's commercial.
We're going to Lil Jon's today. Take our homework jewelry and to see our guest today. Hey, Lil Jon's all the way. For he pays you top dollar and you get your cash today.
Gold hit a historical high over $1,400 an ounce. Now is the time to sell your unwanted jewelry. Remember, don't mail it in.
Bring it in and get your cash today.
All right, what's next? Deadneck says, a failed adult cartoon that tried to surf off the early Simpsons popularity wave. I did a copyright test on Capital Critters when we first started this because I was curious about this and it got locked down. So sadly, we will. Ah, that's loud. Yes. Weird. Why are the cockroaches coated black? Hey, Capital Critters. I couldn't help but notice that using subtle cues such as the fashion choices as well as the switch from generic patriotic music to like smoother jazz music that you are suggesting through a series of aesthetic clues that the cockroaches are black people. And that seems like a huge gross mistake that you shouldn't make. Hi, it's me, media guy. I went to college and have eyeballs and can now recognize these things. Honestly, I'm kind of glad we don't have to watch that, or at least we can't. I'm glad that we're not allowed to watch that. Hell yeah, Maverick Pond summertime loan commercial. Reeves donated for this one and says, I'll see you in Dallas, mother puppet. Hell yeah.
No better way to beat the heat than a nice cool swim.
Die, my water bill. Come on,
get
a brother some slack!
Super Pond Woman, to the rescue!
Oh my god.
Leaving your bank account drained? Come to Maverick Pond, where our fast-friendly staff will help keep you afloat. Just ask for a loan on a variety of things, like flat-panel TVs, tablets, trailers, games, computers, lawn equipment. And don't forget, you don't have to sell your gold. Just ask for a loan.
Great deals!
Faster. It's Maverick Pond!
3574911! Okay. I'm glad he could pay his water bill. Oh, Professor Pig donated for this one and says, 2000s Flash cartoons, you say? Hell yeah, a Weebles production.
Mmm.
Ingram Randomer.
Hey.
Ingram Randomer.
Ingram Randomer.
Randomer.
I used to go to Weeble stuff every fucking day. Everyone loves Magical Trevor because the things that he does are ever so clever. Look at him there with his Something is something. Pure and simple. It's made of magic and with a little flick. Yeah, 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 the cow is back. Betcher, 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 mushroom, mushroom. Feathery, leathery whip, thank you. You guys know better than me. Where can you see lions? Only in Kenya. Oh, it's an escrow. Good. Narwhals, narwhals swimming in the ocean.
No. Go.
Running good, very pure and simple.
Goddamn. I love goddamn Weeble stuff. Vince Omni donated for this and said, potential dumpster show, I must say. You know what? I completely forgot about the completely mental misadventures of Ed Grimley. I forgot that this was a show. I've never even attempted to do a copyright check on it. If this passes, we absolutely got to watch an episode. We'll do this, Gravedale High, and then I'll track to either like, what were the other comedian tie-in shows? There was Camp Candy. We know Bobby's World gets shut down. Life with Louie? What else? Life with Louie, Bobby's World, Camp Candy, Ed Grimley. There had to have been maybe one of the, like an Ace Ventura or The Mask, one of those Jim Carrey cartoons they did. I would love an all 90s comedian complete dumpster. That would be a fun night. The God, the Devil, and Bob. Who was that? That was Stuart French, right? Lil Bill? I don't know if Lil Bill. Okay. There's a difference between having a comedian in the show and like having a comedian-based show. Anyway, Vince Omni donated for this. Let's give it a watch. Oh, this is kind of rad. Oh, this is so Canadian. This reeks of Canadian animation. Oh my God. That fake Grandpa Munster and everything. Count Floyd, that's right, Count Floyd. Sorry. Oh, I kind of really want to watch that now. Kind of really a lot of. Okay, all right. I don't know who requested this, but the media share just completely borked this. Sinestro, if you actually donated for this one, I would be surprised, but this is definitely something got its wires crossed. Yeah, no, you didn't donate for this juicy. Gingerbeard, thank you for the juicy fruit commercial.
Gotta have sweet, gotta have juicy fruit. Nothing satisfies like it. Juicy fruit, the gotta have sweet gum.
Was that Aaron Paul? I thought for a second it looked like Aaron Paul, but I didn't say anything. That could very easily be Aaron Paul. Gingerbeard confirms it is. That's why he did it, probably. Come, bitch. Juicy Fruit actually has a fascinating history because, you know, everybody back in the day when Juicy Fruit mattered, people would always point out that it like doesn't taste like any specific fruit flavor. It's just kind of this weird, sweet, generic everything. Genghis John says, I met Aaron Paul a few times. He's a sweetie. Oh. And the actual story is the flavoring that they use for Juicy Fruit isn't any specific fruit extract. It's actually a chemical compound. I think it's called isoamyl acetate that was easily extracted from the some byproduct of the whiskey distilling process. And in Chicago, when Wrigley's was getting started, or like not started, but picking up steam, it was located near a lot of whiskey distilleries. So they got the ingredient for cheap. And that was like how Juicy Fruit came into existence. Torgo's donating for another weird ass old board game. He says, a game about flim-flamming and bamboozling your beloved family. Nothing like a good old fashioned lie your teeth off to the people closest to you game.
It's a great deal, believe me, it's a great deal.
You bought it, pal! It's a gush.
This is Trust Me, where it can be hard to know who to trust or when to trust them.
Trust me, Dad, this investment's worth it.
A game where you try to get people to invest in your property.
You can trust me, Grant.
Nope, too risky.
You can make a lot of money and win,
I'll do
or
it.
Lose a lot.
Mom and Dad, you've been had.
Oh, no.
A family game. You, from Parker Brothers.
You know that kid grew up to get into crypto. Absolutely, that kid grew up and started hawking NFTs. Oh my God, and that was it. That was it. God, that felt like a long queue. But we're back to cartoons. We're back to cartoons. Whew, we still got a bunch more commercials. So if you haven't seen yours yet, don't worry. It is probably in the queue. There's like a 2% chance it got eaten by media share. But statistically, if you know, you probably have your commercial ready to go. But for now, let's get back to the cartoons. And we're going to revisit a pretty princess. We've watched a couple of episodes. And I'm excited for the it's a unique energy that we have for this one. If you saw the thumbnail over on YouTube, you probably already know what it is. It's Princess Guinevere and the Jewel Riders. And this one is called Home Sweet Heartstone. And I'm excited. We're bouncing around a little for this one because people have been warning me on Twitter that like there's some episodes that don't even have Princess Kale.
Enjoy your Zoa.
Our beautiful goth mommy. Some episodes are just like kind of slow. So I was scanning around and this one, this is episode 9. And it looks like it's got a whole mess of bullshit. Lady Kale, you fake fan. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mixic. I know you are the number one keeper of mommies for this show. You are one of the many priestesses of the cult of dark mommies that we have accumulated on this stream. Anyway, here we go. Oh, shit. This one's Princess Starla. I still have no idea why some episodes are Guinevere, some are Starla.
Together as one.
Jewel Power.
We're here, everyone. Heartland Farms. Oh, it's good to be home. I always love coming here.
Do you think your parents really found a Prism Fox?
Even Merlin would be impressed. Prism Foxes are legendary creatures.
According to the old songs, the voice of the Prism Fox is very magical.
What happened to them?
As far as we know, one day they just disappeared.
I wonder how it got here to Avalon.
That's part of the mystery. Dad and Mom can't communicate with it. They're hoping my Heartstone can help.
Hi, Dad!
Tamara!
Hi, sweetheart.
Hi, Dad!
Yeah.
Bessie?
Hello,
what?
Girls. Hi, Doc. Good to see you again, Doc.
Tamara, Starla, Alan.
God damn, Doc locked it down.
Hi, Mom. This is Sunstar, Charity. We're jewel riders now.
Oh, my dears, I'm so proud of you both.
Thank you.
Look at how your babies have grown. Tamara, I'm anxious for you to check out our newest arrival.
Let's go.
She's over here.
Oh.
What?
Can it really be?
What?
You don't look so special.
Jesus. Let the kitsune guide you. What?
What a wonder.
I'm sorry, does it talk in Moog synthesizer? Weird.
What a wonderful sound. We don't know her name or how she got here.
What?
She just showed up. It's all right, little one. We're friends. Let the magic of the Heartstone and music's helping hand reach out with love and friendship to help us understand.
Wait, what?
Look,
what?
Magic.
Does the fox have Gooseman powers?
What happened?
We must be careful. These foxes have powerful magic.
Well, this one seems sweet. Her name is Kit. I got that much before the magic backfired.
What?
She's saying something.
Come on, little one. You can do it.
Ooh, remarkable. It's about to speak a word.
What?
Mommy.
Gross.
I am not your mommy.
Not your mommy either.
No, honey, I'm not your mommy. Don't be afraid. We're your friends.
Mommy.
What? What?
Tamara, it talks with music. Perhaps it can respond to music.
Good idea, Archie.
What?
All your instruments are still in your room, dear. Let's go.
Wait, what? So much is happening. So much is happening. Mixic, thank you for doing the deep research. And says it was called Starla internationally, and then some wires got crossed with the DVD distribution, and they put the wrong version for some of the episodes. Okay. Okay. All right. Just so I can understand. Just so like I can wrap my head around this. They're visiting Pink Lady's farm. And then they're like, they meet the dad, they meet the hot farm hippie mama. And like, they take care of the magic animals, because to be a star writer means you need like a magical pet thingy. And they're like, and check out this fucking weirdo. The weirdo fox thing that can only talk in Moog synth noises. Freaks out, releases mommy magic, cuddles up to the owl boy. And then they just start jamming out. Am I caught up? Does anybody understand what is happening?
All your instruments are still in your room, dear. Let's go.
And immediately they start playing like honky tonk music. Shooby dooby doop. Shooby dooby doop. Also, God, these characters are off model. God damn. I'm sorry. Let's just gaze. Gaze into the face of horror here. Just what am I looking at? What am I looking at? What are we doing? This was a mistake. This whole stream was a mistake. The YouTube chat's still broken. I'm dizzy. I'm sweaty. I don't understand any of this. Why it should be do- I've only heard 3 seconds of this song, and I hate it. I hate it so much. Oh.
Oh, baby, Heartland Farm is for a baby.
Dolly, pardon me. This is bullshit. Also, bears are not a farm animal. Elephants are not farm animals. Giraffes are not farm animals. Wildcard, it's like gem that you order from Wish. Oh my God. Oh my God. Ugh.
Heartland Farm is where I go. Feels just like my second home. Heartland Farm, you gotta see. Place you go to let them sing. Oh, Heartland Farm. Heartland Farm. Heartland Farm. Yeah, Heartland Farm.
Hippo Butt Bongo. We got it with the hippo butt bongo. You're just throwing hippo butt bongo in the mix. Mystic, when you see her, you'll know.
Wonderful. She sure seems happy now. I've got some special bubbleberry pies for everyone.
Bubbleberry pies, my favorite.
Me too. Can we stay here with Kit tonight, please? Oh, please.
Of course you can.
A prism fox in Avalon. How horrible!
It is too terrible to believe.
Quiet! I'm tuning it.
The prism fox won't be able to resist my magic call.
God, I wish that were me.
Enjoy your Zoa.
Oh. What is... Ugh. What the fuck? What the fuck is happening? This is a horror show. This is a nightmare. This is actually disturbing me on a cellular level. My brain is everybody else is feeling the same way, right? Everyone's brains is just yelling, wrong. This is wrong. Turn away. Something is wrong, right?
Blasted thing. I can't tell if it's working.
Hydro Squeegee, thank you for the Bezos bucks.
I heard that. Come to me, great and powerful Prism Fox.
And yet, despite everything, I'm still here for her.
Mom? What are you?
God, I wish that were me.
You're the Prism Fox? You're so short.
I'm gonna do that to Fleshwife as soon as it's the second she gets home. She's gonna be like, mommy, and she's gonna be like, did you have a bad time at the dumpster today? And I'm gonna be like, yes, how did you know?
I suppose you'll get bigger. What is that? Well, your call is certainly magical. Maxie, your little dweezil is home.
Yeah, double for me.
What the fuck?
Snap out of it, you dweezils. Can't you see it's the magic of the Prism Fox? Be quiet, all of you.
Torgo says, every time the fox says mommy, I feel an immense, unexplainable sadness. Torgo, I'm just going to go ahead and say, it is a very explainable sadness that you are feeling right now. It is one of the most explicable reactions you could have. A menagerie of simps.
Stop this noise at once! Okay. See? Nice little fox. Good baby. All right, I'll take the whole lot of you. Animals to last me a lifetime. As for you, my little pretty. You and I are going to make beautiful music together.
Wow. Wow, that scene is going to haunt me forever.
Tamara, what's wrong? I've had the strangest dream. I'm going to check on the babies. Cleo? Spike? Sugar? What's happened?
The Prism Fox is gone!
Tracks, lots of them, headed out. I'd say a few hours ago.
Oh, my babies! It's never been so quiet here. We'll find them.
Right.
Be careful.
Jewel Riders, let's ride.
Long was here. Thank you for the follow.
Let's see. I've got bears and puppies, a few pigs, some tigers, a monkey.
I don't see any animals.
What are you talking about?
What?
Grim, turn around.
Thank you.
not sure. There are so many different tracks. My Heartstone may be able to find Cleo, Sugar, and Spike. Do it. That way. Let's move out.
Vasty, of course. It's time to jewel. Yeah, wait. How did they? Why are they? What the fuck? Ah, yes, the bagpipes that make you think she's a mom.
Look, it's Kale. If she harms one hair on those babies, she's got some kind of musical instrument.
Tamara, use your Heartstone to amplify your music. Call to Kit.
Archie, you brought all the instruments?
Well, actually, I did.
Archie, I could kiss you.
Weird.
By the magic of the Heartstone.
We all see it. We all see it. I don't understand why it's there. I don't understand what is happening. But it's... Was this meant to be aired? Was this meant for human consumption? Was this entire project a bizarre tax write-off and nobody thought anybody would ever watch? How does this get through? How does this not, like, raise any fucking red flags? Are we serious right now? This might be the end of Princess Starla and the Jewel Riders. I think the Jewel Riders might have had their last ride with this goddamn clusterfuck of an episode. I can't even... It's there! I keep blinking, hoping that it'll, like... No, still there! Still there! What the fuck?
Riders.
Oh, I'm sorry. El Condor, you said this show was somebody's fetish, and here's the thing. It's the production values are so bad. It's so bad that any latent horniness feels, and by latent I mean completely on the surface horniness, feels like terrible. Yeah, Mew and Loverboy says, yeah, it's definitely someone's fetish money pit. Maybe. Weird.
Come to me, my precious things.
Weird.
Not you.
Why? The animation has fallen off a cliff. We're in Zelda CDI territory. We are in full CDI territory.
Not you.
Archie, violin. Bow.
It was never on a cliff. It was always in free fall.
No match for my dark stone.
What? An evil pipe organ. What? Wait, why are they? Okay. The music makes the baby animals go mommy mode. And so they were going to counter it with the power of Princess Rockabilly. And so now they're doing like a battle of the bands for the souls of baby animals, I guess. Jesus Christ. It's It's like a Barnyard Commando's car wreck. Like, I can't look away, but I wish I could. I wish I could.
It's not working. I need jewel power.
By the magic of the sunstone.
By the magic of the moonstone.
Jewel Riders.
Oh my god. why did that shot extra break me? Why is the horses a rhythmically gumming a tambourine? So dumb. This is levels of dumb I did not think were possible. You could just not make the show. You can just say, never mind, no show. It's too, like, we don't want to do it. Oh my god.
Direct hit.
Moonstone for illusion, sunstone to help things grow. Get ready, Jewel Riders. Let's go, go, go.
Terrible.
Let's rock.
Ugh.
Rufus, Twig, hit it.
What? Vasty, that's very funny.
Going somewhere?
Kale's got Kit.
Oh no! What is this? Put me down!
What? What? Yeah, what happened? What the fuck happened? If even the characters have to go, what the fuck just happened? You probably did a bad job explaining what the fuck happened.
Blown away.
What do we do?
We must carry on like the dweezels we are.
Ugh.
Well, you're found now.
Poor Kit! Is she gone?
I don't know. They vanished into the wild magic.
Look!
What? Kit. Wait, the fox just dumped her in the void?
Mama!
This is upsetting. Just all the animals just chanting mama as, like, what?
It seems what? Kit can ride the wild magic. Maybe she got lost from her parents.
If we form an enchanted jewel circle, we may be able to help her.
Oh, that's your answer to everything.
Let's try.
You can't just form a jewel magic circle.
Sunstone. By the magic of the moonstone. By the magic of the heartstone. By the magic of the enchanted jewels, wherever she may roam, help our friend find where her heart lies. Help her find her home.
What? What?
Listen, do you hear it?
Yes, yes.
This is...
Everyone sing with us. Sing loud and true. Little Kit needs us. Help us get through.
Wait, were they talking to the audience? They didn't sing. They just shouted, "Mommy." Fuck, this is bad. This is so bad. This is incredibly, unspeakably bad. Like, the entire production through line was just full of cocaine and horror. Nobody should be, nobody. This had a writer?
Kit.
Thank you, my children.
I thought you only spoke in music.
We speak to you through the wild magic, heart to heart stone.
We had feared for Kit's safety.
We know of the jewel riders.
Where do you come from? I mean, there's so much we don't know about you.
We live in lands far away. We travel the wild magic. Kit is just learning and got lost.
The wild magic is so unstable these days.
We're doing what we can to make things right.
Perhaps one day you may visit us.
We'd like that very much.
You have many adventures ahead of you. Take heart in your friends, for you may call us friends.
How can we ever find you again?
Call with your heart. Kit will hear you.
Friends! Gee, I'm gonna miss Kit!
Why?
Me too.
The fox thing did nothing? You literally, we were like, hi, this is a fox thing. It bellowed in beep boops, cried mommy, and then hypnotized you all into a magic battle of the bands, and then it killed a lady. Why do you, what?
Go, Tamara.
She's gone home.
Where is that?
Oh, and the
home is where you.
God, look at these models. Look at this shit. Look at this fucking awful shit. Look at I could draw better than this. This is just hot dog shit. Oh my God. And I know the nice people at Jewel Writers Archives care deeply about this show. And like there's got to be some juice here. But fucking hell.
You're loved where your heart is.
Wait! Come back here! Oh, Tamara!
Quick, Tamara! Do something!
Wait, what?
This way to Heartland Farm!
What the fuck? Ah! Oh, thank God.
Where are you, witchy thing?
I got tossed out of the wild magic into a tree.
What?
We're coming.
Come and get me this instant.
What?
Mommy.
Come back here, you dumb dragon.
What? What is happening? Why is it happening? To whom is it happening? Oh my god. I'm speechless. I am fucking speechless. I cannot believe we just watched that. I am fundamentally shaken by what we just witnessed. Like, and Lady Kale went fucking hog wild on a bagpipe, and I still didn't like this episode. The guy who directed this episode created Galaxy Rangers. Well, now I don't know what to think. Jesus Christ in heaven, Lord protect me and protect everybody. How did we get here? From whence did we get here? Why did we get here? That was actually insane. That was actually beyond reasonableness. God, there was camel toe. There was camel toe. I don't know. Everybody stop yelling at me. I thought this, it looked interesting. There were like wacky animals and a battle of the bands. I just scrubbed through it. I didn't think it would be just pure nonsense. Oh my God. Oh my God. Yeah, wow. It's gonna take a lot for Jewel Riders to redeem itself from that. Wow. Wow, that was a lot of bullshit. An unprecedented amount of bullshit. I thought it was fine, said Lolo Frosty. Well, you're stronger than us. You're stronger than me. I am fundamentally shaken to my core. Oh, no. Oh, great. Now we got Eagle Man. Now Eagle Man's here. Fantastic. Who donated for this? Sote donated for this and says, I'm high on hard Mountain Dews. Let's go.
What's that?
Do you have insurance on this car?
No.
It must be Eagle Man.
I've got something for you.
This was better acted, executed, and written.
Oh, look at those low rates.
That was better. That was better than goddamn Jewel Riders. I mean, of course, Mixic liked it. It had extra horny mommy scenes. She was off model and animated weird, but they were there. Keeping the commercial train going, Torgo donated for this and said, you will never find a more wretched scum of a wretched hive of scum and villainy. Oh, look at those cool children.
Are you?
We are from Earth.
Never heard of it.
We're here for Nissan-Kiss Fruit Rocks Fruit Snacks.
There are two kinds, Fruit Rocks Meteorites and Galactic Gems. Both are made with real fruit.
Wow, you get a lot.
You can also get a free Fruit Rocks box with two proofs of purchase. Details on package.
Fruit Rocks, never heard of them.
What planet are you from?
New Fruit Rocks, the fruit snack of the future.
Mixic, I respect your wishes. I respect that. Oh, Pardobon donated for this one and said, let's get this dumpster fired up. I mean, I love Don Hertzfeld. I absolutely love Don Hertzfeld. I don't know if we'll be able to watch this all. This, like Don Hertzfeldt is a working filmmaker. I don't think we'll be able to just cavalierly show this on stream without a copyright warning. So I'm only going to give this a couple of seconds. And also, it's like a whole ass short film. But yes, this is legendary. This is like a hallmark moment in the history of millennial humor. God, like nothing was funnier than this, than the first time I saw it. Like choking on the floor, unable to contain my laughter. Lolo, you've never
my
heard of this?
My spoon is too big. My spoon is too big. My spoon is too big. Mm-hmm. I am a banana.
Tuesday's coming. Did you bring your coat?
I live in a giant bucket.
I'm so gonna get copyright tagged on this. Worst case scenario, the VOD won't show up and I'll have to edit this part out.
You're watching the Family Learning Channel. And now, angry ticks fire out of my nipples.
This is it.
Say, do you want to go see a movie?
Mm-hmm.
I'm feeling fat and sassy.
Do you?
Honestly, I'm getting such like warm tingles. That little thing going, sweet Jesus. God. It's interesting watching this now. Oh, and that was... And MediaShare decided that was enough. Fair enough. Hey! Hey, it's Gordy Dodd! As an obnoxious 17-year-old, I'd probably love these and force all my friends to watch them. Absolutely. 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 MediaShare did rejected. Modern Bard donated for this one and says, here's the one that MediaShare ate last week. Oh, thank. Well, thank you for resubmitting it. Modern Bard, you're always, thank you for your continual support of the stream. And thank you for being a good sport about the fact that nothing I do works most of the time.
The tents go up, the furniture goes out, and that means three ring savings at Dodd's Furniture and Mattress.
It's the greatest sale on earth.
Right now, find the perfect furniture at the perfect price under the big top. The tent sale at Dodd's Furniture on Finlayson.
Hurry, step right up.
He won't be undersold. Torgo, another longtime supporter who shares not only his insanely apocryphal knowledge of bizarre board games and pizza parlors, but also like just covering my ass for a lot of research whenever I'm befuddled on stream. Thank you, Torgo. Says, only the second most cursed Chuck E. Cheese knockoff I have an ad for tonight. You know what? Tom Ska's all right. I would love to watch some Tom Ska on a Flash Tune episode.
What can you buy for 10 cents these days? Video games, and lots of them, at Dimes and Critters in the 5 Mile Shopping Center. That's right, just a dime buys you a turn on your favorite video game. And while you're here, try our piping hot pizza. That melted cheese and taste.
Oh, no.
And by the way, the entertainment by the Critters.
Oh, no.
So come to Dimes and Critters in the 5 Mile Shopping Center.
Oh, those look so nasty.
So come to free. So by the way, the entertainment by the Critter Band.
Hey, have you ever wondered if a robot could be stinky? Well, now you can, because we got the stinkiest robots in all of 1984.
It's free, so come to Dimes and Critters in the 5 Mile Shopping Center for a great value and a great time.
Oh, those are really bad. Oh, those were, those are even, that's like below Showtime Pizza. Gingerbeard donated for this one and says, my favorite flavor of Doritos, Cool Rock.
Mystic Music presents Cool Rock.
Is this cool? Okay. I'm calling it now, like, everything they've shown so far are explicitly examples of, like, cringy and like, the kind of music that a nerdy neighbor would listen to in a bad sitcom. Like, all of these bands are, like, punchlines in a 90s movie. This is the least cool rock I've ever seen.
The songs are hot, but the rock is cool.
Literally a meme song. Literally, Weezer did this song as a joke because like Gen Zers started listening to it ironically. Tiffany. Yeah, Boy George. The Thompson
cool
Twins?
Rock, you get two cassettes or two CDs with all your favorite hits from the 80s and 90s.
Yeah! Oh my god! Dancing for money, do what you not meant to do.
Cool Rock remembers the special times.
Actual punchlines. I've never heard that one. Yeah, Jesus. Like that's a Kumail Nanjiani bit.
Call now to get this great collection of cool rock.
Oh, Taylor Dane. Taylor Dane, also a Tig Notaro bit.
Cool Rock contains 35 chart toppers for only $19.95 for cassettes or $24.95 for CDs.
Meridins, how many cool human beings have been conceived to these cassettes?
Or send $19.95
an entire generation
for two CDs
has been born from Cool Rock-based orgasms.
Y.O. Monument, Colorado. Or call 1-800-615-0099. That's 1-800-615-0099.
Relunch? Real Uncle? Real Uncle Jay, maybe? I almost got your name right. If you look in the stream description, or if Nightbot kind of swoops in. There's a link to the stream, the Streamlabs link that you can submit via media share, and you do the YouTube link through there for donations of $2 and up. I'm sorry. Torgo donated for this and says, more stable than Bitcoin.
Quest to bring you the newest fruit roll-ups continues. First, we tried rubber rolls, but that was too off the wall. Then we thought ghostly rolls would be a stream. They were. Then something made sense. Dollars and cents. New fruity money peel-outs. Tens, hundreds, thousands. A fruity fortune so you can put your money where your mouth is. Fruity money peel-outs. What fun fruit roll-ups will we roll out with next?
Oh, no. Rusty Shackleford, what is this? What is this? Is this... This feels like a parody ad. I'm going to click it, but I swear to God, if this is like a raunchy 2000s era parody commercial, I'm going to shut this shit down.
What's the matter, Ronnie? Masculine itching?
How'd you know?
When I experience masculine itching, I reach for Extra Strength Itch Stopper Plus.
The phrase masculine itching is beautiful.
How does it work?
When your body heats up, Ronnie, enzymes mixed with bacteria can cause unsightly discomfort.
Boy, howdy.
But with just two fingers of the patented oily balm applied to the affected area, you
can... Get Tiva. Skip this if you don't want to. Learn more at Tiva.com.
Rusty Shackleford, I shouldn't have doubted you. I shouldn't have doubted you. You knew what you were doing. Your masculine itching has been soothed by the greasy balm of humor. Gingerbeard donated for this one and said, Scooby-Doo is interested in a UK bank's reward system.
Barker Brothers bonkers with
it. And of course, goddamn, media share is being wacky with it. All right, this is a Torgo ad for a board game. Don't worry, I'll make it right, Gingerbeard.
Funny twisted track can send you backward to go forward, or forward to go back. The bonkers board keeps changing with every single play. With bonkers cards and bonkers dice, it is not the same game twice. And you go back and forward faster in a bonkers kind of fun. And you're certain that you're losing when suddenly you've won. Bonkers is fun, bonkers is nice, bonkers is never the same game twice.
Bonkers from Parker Brothers.
Gingerbeard, I believe this is what you wanted to buy.
Zoinks! The mummy! That's the place! Turn left! Like now!
Wow! That was quite an entrance. Can I help at all?
I sure hope so. We heard you give rewards to some of your customers.
What?
And now seem like the perfect time to pop by. Right, Scoob?
Yeah, Raggy.
That's right. As a reward current account customer, you can get money back from the types of places you like to shop. And eat.
Eat? Yum!
In fact, I know exactly where you should go.
Boy, he was right, Scoob. Man, that was delicious. Oh, thanks.
Raggy.
Yikes! Run, Scoob!
Goodbye.
Nice work, guys.
Scooby Dooby Doo!
I can't believe Scooby-Doo would sell out in that fashion. The most integrity-filled goddamn cartoon ever. Ooh, Narazzo. Ooh. Maybe we'll watch this at the end of the stream. I do like Narazzo a lot. They're kind of like Korea's answer to Tenacious D. Anyway, Modern Bard donated for this one, and it's another goddamn Gordy Dodd, and I'm so happy to see it. Modern Bard says, from the furthest reaches of the world, Gordy wants all to know he won't be undersold.
Gordy wants the world to know that Dodd's Furniture is having its
one day sale.
This Saturday only.
One day sale.
Save up to 70%.
One day sale.
This Saturday only at Dodd's, Victoria and Nanaimo.
Oh, God. God, I want a Nanaimo. Vince Omni donated for this and said, I found this deep in the dumpster. A Chuck Lorre early production. Sorry, you can stop at any time. Oh, no. Oh, you know I hate clowns. You know I hate clowns. But I do like Chuck Lorre theme songs. Fuck, I'm torn. Let's see what you got. Oh, they're upsetting. I don't like these.
Big Top leads the little clown. The dumbo makes real funny sounds. Jacob's got a silly song. And Tickle giggles all day long. Frankie has a short to play.
He'll throw a cream by someone's way.
Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh, okay.
And clownimals don't have clown face on like little clowns.
That's how they're born. Little clowns of happy days.
Oh, God. All right. Oh shit, the Ernest Splash Mountain thing. Okay. All right. I have to, my phone's about to die and I use that for face tracking, so I got to run and get a battery for this thing. We'll finish this round of commercials in a second. I'm going to get up. I'm walking away for a hot second. But in the meantime, watch some Narazzo. The Tenacious D of Korea. I'll be right back.
We are back.
We'll be right back. They got a whole, that's just like chapter one of the Narazzo saga. They got good. I mean, we could go hard all day on that, but thank you for giving me that second. The phone is plugged in. The phone, I repeat, is plugged in. We're still ready to go. The party can't stop, won't stop. When we last left our commercial cue, Deadneck donated and said, "Sorry to disappoint y'all. I missed this little factoid on the Whizbrew episode about Splash Mountain. Ernest was the first to ride one of the Splash Mountains." There's a whole half-hour Disney special that they did at the time.
"This is the first time, remember, that anyone has taken on Splash Mountain. So they want to make sure that everything is perfectly set and the conditions are just right. Here he goes. Ernest is taking off.
Wish I'd brought a book."
Perfect. Torgo, continuing his nonstop fun fruit snack assault, donated for this one and says, "They found the technology to make the trees scarier." Oh, no.
Sunkiss searches and searches for fun fruit trees. The only tree is funny enough to grow sun-kissed fun fruits. Every chewy one is real fruity fun. And now we've discovered Sunkissed Fun Fruits Cream Supreme.
Ooh.
They're covered with yogurt.
Cream Supremes.
And filled
with fun. Ew. Ew.
Sunkissed Fun Fruits Cream Supremes.
Something like both enticing and horrifying about the phrase Cream Supremes. Torgo, I don't know if this is real or not. Maybe MediaShare's acting fucky. Because it says you requested for something called Pizza Planet 1984. Which makes me believe there is not, this isn't, okay, Gingerbeard, that one is yours. All right.
"Colonel, long time no see."
"Snake, today's briefing is of the utmost importance."
"What is it, Colonel?"
"I'll be telling you all about the Ford Focus SE."
"Ford?"
"Yes, Snake. You should know, the Ford Focus SE comes with a standard rear-view camera. Plus, it has an EPA estimated 36 highway miles per gallon."
"EPA estimated 36 highway miles per gallon? That's remarkable."
"Yes, Snake. The Focus SE is the perfect vehicle for..."
Oh no, it cut off. Fuck! All right, well, Torgo, I know this is what you requested.
"Now you can celebrate your birthday with Pepperoni and..."
At
the Pizza Planet. For $5.50 per person, you'll get pizza.
Why was this a thing?
And an ice cream sundae. Plus a special birthday show with Pepperoni and a visit with Sylvester Stallion and a member of the Buffalo Stallions team. Everyone at your party...
Like, I knew there was Chuck E. Cheese, and I knew that there was Showtime Pizza.
And the birthday person will receive...
I had no idea there were so many goddamn
at the Pizza Planet
horror show pizza places.
Now, back to our program.
That's... How are there so many? Vince Omni, I don't even know what this is anymore. You said, "All I got was the books." Great.
Here comes the Sweet Pickles bus.
Smart moms know how kids' minds grow.
What?
Sweet Pickles.
Your child's head start for school starts with his free Sweet Pickles preschool bus. There are stickers, games, puzzles, and hours of fun
inside.
The bus is
learning symbolic.
Basic skills like numbers and letters. See,
they would just send you stuff
to
through the mail.
6-year-old. So they'll love to learn. Honest.
"I think it's excellent. Sweet Pickles is great."
Call this number today and we'll send you this Sweet Pickles bus filled with dozens of learning activities free. We'll also send your first activity pack on approval for only $3.49 plus delivery. If you like it, you'll get two new packs about every 4 weeks.
Okay, it's like a Zoo Book scam.
There's never any obligation to buy. Call now and we'll send the Sweet Pickles bus to your door.
Smart moms know how kids' minds grow.
Thanks, Mom.
Sweet Pickles.
Call now.
Vince Omni, if you're old, I'm a fucking grandfather. I, like, vaguely remember that. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, KiwiCo's, like, the same deal. All right. All right. It's time for our last cartoon of the night. I wanted to mix it up, so listen. Listen, Princess Guinevere / Starla, pretty rank, pretty bizarre, pretty upsetting. So let us go back to a deep and plentiful well of surprising quality, the Mighty Max animated series from the 90s. This one, so I've been struggling to find a source because a lot of the episodes have like really bad audio hiss on it. Like viewable but distractingly prevalent audio hiss. And I've been looking around and apparently there's like no DVD version. It's not available on any streaming service. And even the even some bootleg websites are like, hey, I tried to fix the hiss. I put it through an audio filter. It's as good as I could get it. So like I'm aware that there's a hiss, but I think this is going to be a good ass episode nonetheless. My gathered here today, associated Twitch randos, lurkers, longtime supporters, and of course, the secret weirdos still hanging out at YouTube, even though I couldn't figure out how to get the chat going. It's Mighty Max time. Condor, Bobot also just seems to have been completely asleep at the wheel in terms of preserving and copywriting their shows. So there's a reason. God, that's a lot of writing credits.
Who's there?
I sure hope I don't get mauled to death.
Got in the tree, are ya? Come on. Hey, you're not Puss-Puss.
So, my little kumquat, run away with me to the castle, eh?
Oh, stop!
The moonlight on the Mediterranean will sparkle in your eyes like diamonds. So you will be mine, and we will be married tonight.
Anything! Anything!
Mom getting married? To some guy with a bad French accent I haven't even met yet? Not without inviting me.
Oh, Martha, you tell the funniest jokes. Hi, honey, what's up?
Nothing.
Oh, wait, almost forgot. This came in the mail today. Okay, Martha, tell me another one.
Hey, I didn't order this. Thor, have you been sending away for Godzilla outtakes again? Virgil?
Greetings, mighty one. I fear the world needs you once again.
What? Didn't that just save it last week?
Indeed you did. But you are to join us post-haste. Take the portal by the septic tank to Oregon. Turn right at the Sequoia. Third trunk from the left, then on to the Chinese Laundry, and...
Whoa, hold the phone, would you, Verge? If I don't get this all down, I'm liable to end up in Albania. So, this is Dunaglen, Scotland, huh? Not exactly my kind of town. I wonder where Virgil and Norman are. Hello, what's this?
Hey, just what we needed. Another gruesome killer in Dunaglen Abbey. It's the fifth one this week.
Excuse me, did you say... killing? You see, I was supposed to meet someone here. Two someones, in fact. One of them's a chicken.
No, Lenny. No chickens being killed here.
Jesus.
Oh, for a second there, I thought it might be one of my friends. Maybe you've seen him?
Well, no, maybe I have, maybe I haven't. Maybe I've got them locked in my station house. Suspects like you.
Nay, likely, Chief Constable. I made this from the marks on the body, same as on all the others. Who you know for a suspect's got an overbite like that?
Oh, come on, Chief. Look at that beaky face. You know they're innocent. Why hold them?
They're my suspects, lad. I cannot be letting them go.
Suspects? What about their teeth? Dentures don't lie, man. Baby proof of plenty for you to be letting his friends go.
This woman is drawn too unattractive for her not to be a villain.
Oh, same for the boy you got back there, Cameron.
Professor McDougal, your newfangled plaster castings don't prove a thing to me. Anyone that wants can have a set of dentures made. I take myself.
Well, looks like you're going to be sitting this one out a while.
So it would seem, Mighty One.
Have you no compassion for the wretched human condition right under your nose? Cameron's...
Torgo, thanks for the heads up. The audio balance was completely messed up.
Norman, no! That is, without law, there is only chaos. After all, we are innocent. We must wait for the Chief Constable to let us go.
Thank you, Socrates. Hey, don't you realize there's a killer on the loose out there?
We dare not jeopardize your freedom to act, Mighty One. You are the key to harmony in Dunaglen. Heavens!
Crabby old coat! Cameron's not your man. Will you be ignoring the evidence till all of Dunaglen's lying dead?
Don't go away. I'll check in on you guys later.
You've got to let Cameron go. You've got to let me help him.
Stop bounding me! I want to be released as suspects before the killer's been caught, so help me!
Hey, who's this Cameron guy when he's in town anyway?
The cupbearer?
Obviously hasn't been reading the latest GQ. So you are, Cameron, I presume?
You! You must help me!
Come away from there, laddie! You'll carry no commerce with that lunatic!
Yeah, but who is he? And what's he got to do with all this stuff? Why is he...
No, never you mind, laddie. Here now, have you got logics? We'll have to see to it.
No, wait! Come back! You must help me!
We're so glad to have your Max. Though I do wish you'd picked a better time to be visiting Dunaglen. Ah, these killings, putting a pail on everything. Blame it on the werewolves.
You mean big furry dudes who grow long fangs and hair on their palms and wear bad makeup once a month, like the Wolfman?
Nay, lad. These be werewolves. Wolves who can take on the form of men. When ere the moon's in the night sky, they roam the moors on all fours. Some say they were the original fathers of all wolves. Some say they were men, doomed to be animals forever. But as long as there's been a Dunaglen, the werewolves have been here. Really? Cool.
Here now, shame on your old wife, spreading such old wives' tales. Pay him no mind, boy.
Huh? Then you're kidding? Oh, I gotta tell you, you really had me going there for a sec.
Hey, part of being American, lad, he'll be buying anything.
Policeman's being kind of sus.
Kiss me, Cameron! That blare is from the station house. So much for me sleep tonight.
Chief, what's going on? A wolf just tried to get me. Hey, Chief! Chief, wait up!
Look, cannot talk now. I'm in a hurry.
I made me rounds, and when I got here, Cameron's cell was empty.
Aye, I got eyes, man.
Gavin wouldn't have been escaping without someone helping him with the window. Yeah, and that someone must have carried him off, because the only tracks I see out here aren't human. Did you guys hear anything?
Well, I was having a small lay down when the most disturbing howling woke me. Quite lupine, if you ask me.
I knew it! Chief! Chief, I told you there was a wolf outside my window! Oh, for Lottie, get out of there! You're stepping in evidence. Go on home now, go. You'll only be a bother to me here. Huh? Yeah, sure. See you later. Go home? Fat chance, bub. Professor McDougal's right. He is a crabby old whatever.
No, not Lupine the Third, Pardo Bond.
That sounds like a...
werewolf! Ooh, damn. Donnie Lurch says, hey, Jared, it's my girlfriend's birthday. Can you please shout out Katie? Thank you for the dono, Donnie Lurch. Happy birthday, Katie. Hi, it's me, Puppet Jared, America's favorite cartoon yelling at person. And I'm so happy that you and Donnie get to celebrate your special day together. And Donnie also says, the funniest thing about Mighty Max is that it's just a reskin of Polly Pocket for boys, and it totally worked. I had many of them. I as well. I don't know, Donnie. I don't know if your girlfriend's watching or not. I'll say happy birthday again when your commercial shows up. But hi, happy birthday to Katie from Donnie via me, Puppet Jared. It's your birthday today. Happy birthday! Hooray! Yes, it's Katie's birthday. Donnie donated $5 for me to say that, and I'm happy about it. Yep. Also, hey, Mutant Lover Boy, thank you for the $2.
The werewolf. It's Cameron. He's the killer.
Is he naked? Are they implying nudity?
No such thing as werewolves, huh? Yeah. Wait till the chief constable sees this. I could have sworn it was this way. Or that. Oh, wait, those lights. Come on! I gotta use the phone! It's an emergency!
The laboratory's closed.
Oh, please, it's really important!
Laddie, and what's so important? You got to be waking the dead?
Cameron, you say? Yes! That's why I gotta get to a phone!
At last!
Oh, gee, I guess I'm just gonna have to find it myself! Oh, boy!
What are you doing here?
Oh, it's you. I'm just looking for a phone, Doc. What is all this stuff?
That? I'm experimenting with a new vaccine for rabies. It's of no importance.
Rabies?
Sorry, lad, no time. He said Cameron's outside.
Hey, lady, you seem to be doing a lot of spooky wolf shit. At the exact same time, a bunch of spooky wolf shit's happening. Well, I'm sure it's nothing. Later.
Yeah, he's a werewolf, and he's the one who's been ripping people up.
Werewolf? But there's no such thing, lad. It's not but a legend. Believe me.
Oh, man, I don't know what to believe anymore. I thought I saw a wolf at the castle, and then he changed into Cameron.
At the castle? Why, is that where you saw Cameron?
Mighty Max is, like, acting surprisingly childlike this episode. Like, he hasn't been making nearly as many weird, dated Catskill comedian references. He hasn't been, like, doing cool skateboard tricks apropos of nothing. Whoever wrote this actually kind of is having a little bit of a subtle hand with their treatment of our bodacious, cool boy main character.
But there's no such thing, lad. It's not but a legend. Believe me.
Oh, man, I don't know what to believe anymore. I thought I saw a wolf at the castle, and then he changed into Cameron.
At the castle? Why, is that where you saw Cameron? Oh, the poor lad. We've got to help him. We've got to get Cameron before the chief. Go. I'll be right behind you.
I hope you know what we're doing, Doc. I don't even know how to get there. Which way? Hey, Doc! Professor McDougal? Where'd she go? Professor McDougal, where are you?
Come on, show us the big monster.
Nice boy. Don't forget, you're not a werewolf. Not a werewolf. There are no such things as werewolves, so it's no big deal.
Show me the big spooky thing.
Oh, if I get out of this, I'll never cut PE class again.
Oh, that's why they got Frank Welker. Remember, somebody pointed out Frank Welker was in this episode a bunch. And it's, of course you get Frank Welker on the werewolf episode, because literally... that snarly animal, like Frank Welker was the voice of like 99% of every weird animal going, like that noise, that sound effect that you associate with monsters in cartoons is Frank Welker.
Open Sesame! Open Saskatchewan! Open or I'm gonna be dead meat!
Like, you're like, hey, that kind of sounds like the Gremlins. That sounds like every other monster thing from every other movie and TV show. And it's all fucking, it's all Welker. It's Welker the whole way down.
Whoa! Nice view. Sure glad I'm not part of it.
You've come.
Cameron, how'd you get here ahead of me? Stay back.
What? Oh, he's dead.
Are you all right, Cupbearer?
You saved me. But you're a werewolf. I mean, first you try to kill me, and now... Hey, how'd you know I'm the Cupbearer?
Werewolf. Aye, that I am. One of the immortal weirs of Donegal, able to change from wolf to man at will. But killer, I'm innocent. My only hope. I've lived for centuries.
Thank you, Donnie Lurch.
Legend of the Mighty One. Now I'm being hunted by a beastly terror out of perdition itself. Only you can save me. Hey, it's him, the monster.
Jesus.
I got an idea. Yeah, that'll work. All we need now is a monster.
Ah, the old drop the chandelier on the thing. Cartoon classic.
Hey there, big, tall, three-headed and ugly! What do you say? Down, Cameron! Jump!
Oh. I'm gonna swing from the chandelier.
Aye, that monster will be troubling us no more. Thank you,
what?
Cupbearer. It's a sorrow my pack could not share any of this. I'm all that's left of them now.
Pack? You mean there are others like you? Werewolves?
Aye, we were mighty and proud once. But then the monster! One by one, the others vanished with nary a trace.
Wait a sec. I've seen them. I know where they are.
What? Are you sure, lad?
I mean, yeah. Back at the professor's place. Come on, we'll give the chief a call first and then tell him where he can pick up his killer. Well, we tried the front door, the back door, and the side. I guess the professor's not home.
If what you say is true, I fear she's fallen foul of the late and unlamented monster.
What?
There they are, on the tables!
Wow.
Great Scott, what's been done to them? They're immortal creatures and yet barely alive.
Wait, Cameron, what are you doing? They're sick. They need that stuff.
I like the plague. This contraption's been what's making them ill.
But why would the professor do that? And why did she tell me there were no werewolves?
I cannot answer either, lad. Only Professor McDougal can.
Mysterious phone calls in the night.
Your killer's at Dunningland Castle, Mr. Chief Constable.
Indeed. Not here, but stones and rot. Oh, must have rocks in me to be out here in a wild moose chase like this.
Rocks indeed.
Damn, she naked.
Easy does it, gently like. There. Speak to me, love. It's Cameron. What happened to you all?
Oh, they're pretty out of it. I wish Professor McDougal was around to tell us what she was doing.
It's a good thing she is not, or I'd be telling her what I think of her research methods in a most ungentlemanly manner.
Professor McDougal!
Well, now, a good evening to you both. The silverware's in the kitchen, and you'll find some heirlooms in the den. Would you be wanting anything else?
Yeah, answers. What really goes on here? And what's this whole thing all about?
Why, surely, lad. This is what it's all about. A serum, nay, the humor divine. Mysteries of the infinite wrapped in a tiny vial, each drop imbued with a werewolf's immortal essence.
So that's it. You've been milking essence.
You've been... Honestly, this entire episode, I've been kind of quiet because I've just been like genuinely interested in the mystery. But I had to pause for, of course, you've been milking essence. Oh, I should have known all along. You've been milking essence. Of course, you get a bunch of buff furry men strapped to a table, and you can't help but milk their essence for all it's worth.
Drop imbued with a werewolf's immortal essence.
So that's it. You've been milking essence. But you cannot steal a werewolf's immortality, woman. It's non-transferable.
Ha! You feeble-minded were. I'll have more than immortality. I'll have the very power of life itself. This serum's itself the key. Long the universe has waited for someone to bridge the formative world and the material one. I can mold living tissue into any form I can kin. The mysteries of the infinite are answered in this tiny vial, for each drop of elixir's imbued with the light of the golden orb. Aye, more than you know. Well then, here's to the kill. Or should I say, breakfast?
Jesus. Oh no, is this gonna get freaky? Oh, this is gonna get real freaky. Okay. Oh no, it's just the Cerberus again.
Pretty scary, huh?
Aye, but it's not over yet, mighty one. I'd rather I die fighting than let my beloved pack be brought to their knees again.
It's two naked Scottish people wrestling in a lab.
Come on, guys! Hey, you, get back here, and you too! Okay, the werewolf is always right. Get these puppies out of here. Wait a second. Hydrogen gas, electricity. Put them all together, and boop, that monster in her lab will go big time.
What?
There. That should fill her up in minutes, and then... Oh, no! They're getting mauled. Oh, man, I gotta do something. The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
What?
And the taller they are, the sooner the ceiling hits them. Cameron, we gotta blow this joint before it blows. Cameron, did you hear me?
What? This is a lot.
Oh, come on, Cameron, I'm too young to combust.
What? What?
Cameron, she's trapped. Come on! Use your head. You're not just a savage animal. Think of your pack.
Murder.
Another day, another monster blown to bits.
Okay, just so we're clear, Mighty Max blew up a police station? Or was, no, that lab was different from the other lab? The lab was in the police station, right? Weren't his friends in there? That was a weird way to wrap up this. Big mystery, and then in the last 3 minutes, just insanity. The Deus Ex ceiling crank? What do you mean ceiling crank? What do you mean? Ah, yes. The classic piece of equipment we all know, the crank that lowers the ceiling. What? And then he blows it up with hydrogen? That was a lot.
Get down!
Mirrodin, I've been loving your Bloodborne references this entire time.
Another day, another monster blown to bits. And so when the hydrogen filled the room, the sparks from the Jacob's ladder ignited it.
Aye, poor Professor McDougall. It was her fascination with wolves that drove her to turn and kill her, I suppose.
Well, there you are. I suspect it had all along. You see that? Slow but steady gets them every time. Now, as far as the law's concerned, I have me killer. You're all free men. Air and chicken.
Oh, chicken indeed. Eternal gratitude and a pack of...
Wait. Who? Wait, what? Why does he... What is...
It was her fascination with wolves that drove her to turn and kill her, I suppose.
Okay, well, they're blaming her. Yeah.
I suspect it had all along. You see that? Slow but steady gets them every time. Now, as far as the law's concerned, I have me killer. You're all free men. Air and chicken.
Oh, chicken indeed. Eternal gratitude and a pack of facts to you. Fare thee well, cupbearer.
That guy must spend thousands of dollars on clothes. He has like completely evaporated 4 separate outfits this episode alone. Three Wolf Moon, baby. Okay. All right. All right, what are we going to learn about? Wolf anatomy, Scottish folklore, the lizard men that live in the center of the world, hydrogen explodes. What is our lesson? What is our educational fucking thing here?
This week we went to Scotland, which I think is a way cool place. The Scots built lots of castles starting around 1100 to defend themselves from the Vikings and the Normans and everyone else invading their land. They gave the castles names like Dunbarton, Scone, Threave, and Bothwell. Castle Maximus has a nice ring, don't you think? See you next week.
All right. I guess that was educational. I guess. Still. Whew. God, Mighty Max is good. So if the audio wasn't that bad, I think we can watch more Mighty Max. Because I was really worried that the audio quality would be like too distracting. But I mean, if everybody was fine with that, I think we can do that more often. Let's get into the goddamn Mighty Max archives. Why not? There's like a bunch of episodes. They're all pretty good. Oh, that Year of the Rat one was so good. Anyway, Mixix says, I will point out that good shows have less funny commentary. You're not wrong. Oh, it's about balance. This is the eternal struggle of the cartoon dumpster, where it's bad enough to make fun of, but not so bad it hurts. That's the Don't run it through an AI upscaler, Salt2XL, in the YouTube chat. I see you making your secret plans over there. You think I can't see? I can see. Mixic says, bring me the pain. Oh, my God. Ah, pleasure, pain. It's all part of the grand human experiment that is the cartoon dumpster. We have a couple more commercials to get through, and then we're going to say goodnight. But, oh, no. Oh, we're starting strong slash terrible. Oh, no. Why? Why are we doing this? It's Kidz Bop 15. 15 seems like a good number to end on this week. Thanks, Gingerbeard. Because when I arrive, I bring the thing to make you come alive. Let it rock. Let it rock.
It's time to shine like a star with the incredible Kidz Bop 15. Some of today's biggest songs sung by kids for kids.
Okay.
Mix it up on kidsbop.com. Find the best videos, dedicate a song to your friend, or even make your own web show. It's more nonstop fun from some of the
All right.
kids around.
Okay. This is actually kind of a good year. Like we're you know, we got that was Lil Wayne, we got Rihanna. Like these are we're out of the doldrums. We're out of like the darkness, I feel like, with this one. Oh shit, it cut it off. Kidz Bop 15 has my approval. Modern Bard, oh my God. Hell yeah, what? Look at this production value. Look at this Gordy Dodd. This is a good Dodd right here. This is a rare Dodd. Modern Bard donated for this one. Says, this is one of the videos that for some reason was unlisted on YouTube, but no Gordy Dodd will go unfound. Benny Boy, thank you for the weird emotes. I'm happy to have you in the chat. But let's get our Dodd on. In Dodd we trust.
We want to be in the store.
Yay! He said the thing.
Bring you everyday value pricing with customized Canadian-made furniture. Choose the style, choose the color. Buying Canadian means faster delivery and no U.S. exchange rates.
Suck into your heart.
Find fashion.
Did he say suck into your heart? No, he said search, and he has an accent, and that's fine. That's normal.
Exchange rates.
Suck into your heart.
Find fashionable options for condo living. And see the inspiring Palliser guy.
Wait, hold on, Gingerbeard. Is that clone trooper armor? No, that's Darth Vader's little, like, chest piece. No, that's Vader.
Suck into your heart.
Find fashionable options for condo living. And see the inspiring Palliser gallery. Dodd's Furniture and Mattress.
Go back to the beginning. Oh, okay, yeah, that's a clone trooper. His buddy's the clone trooper. I get it. All right.
Faster delivery and no U.S. exchange rates.
Suck into your heart.
Find fashionable options for condo living and see the inspiring Palliser Gallery. Dodd's Furniture and Mattress. Everyday value pricing.
May the Dodd be with you.
TV's Brent donated for this one and says, oh, I don't know how to pronounce this. The Dieppe raid? The Dieppe raid was one of the biggest fuck-ups in the war and killed thousands of Canadians for absolutely no reason. So one of our major telecoms decided to make some money off it. Happy Remembrance Day, Canadians. Oh, God.
Hello?
Hi, Grandpa.
Mark, what a nice surprise. How's your trip?
Oh, it's great. I'm in France.
Ah, Paris. The girls still as lovely as I remember them?
Grandpa. Actually, I'm not in Paris.
Where are you then?
I'm in Dieppe.
Wow, wow.
Grandpa?
I'm glad you're there.
I guess I'm calling to say thanks, Grandpa.
It's great of you to call.
Everything we do connects you to the people, places, and things that matter.
Well, that could have been worse. That's like standard cynical heartstring pulling, right? Oh my God. Oh my God. Vince Omni donated for this TV spot for the Chipmunk Adventure 1987. Vince Omni says, my nomination for another movie dumpster episode. Fucking don't tempt me with a good time. This movie is a fucking trip. This movie is like nightmare fuel, an LCD, LCD, God, I'm a nerd, an LSD trip. It was like hodgepodge together from like a bunch of contracted animation studios. So like from scene to scene, it looks like a completely different movie. If I remember correctly, like, the Chipettes are weirdly sexualized a bunch. There's a lot going on in this movie, man.
We're on our way around the world!
From the deepest sea to the darkest jungle.
Ugh.
To the desert sand.
I will make her!
Okay, good. Oh, good. So we also have a bunch of stereotypes. See, my mind blocks out the racism. Mutant lover boy, don't, ugh.
Dream on, Tiny Tim.
Right, like it's a little too sensual for a Chipette.
The frozen plains of Antarctica. The chipmunks and the Chipettes are heading for adventure.
You better believe it, yeah, 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 the boys are rocking more.
The Chipmunk Adventure starts Friday at a theater near you.
Weird. Vince Omni says, classic mad. Hell yes, spy versus spy. God damn it. Incredible. That was a surprisingly well-made and well-adapted adaptation of those comics. Surprisingly competent job by the Dew team. Modern Bard, is this the same commercial? Oh, okay. Modern Bard, I read this aloud earlier, but once again, drawing attention that Veterans Day is approaching and that, you know, like Modern Bard said himself, for some, the war is over, but the fight in one way or another rages on and that there is hope. Just going to double check that, yeah, this is the same commercial.
We want to be in the sword.
Dodge Furniture is
I'm just going to move on, but thank you once again, Modern Bard. Fifty-six Mouse donated for this one. Oh no, is the juice loose in this? Fucking hell. 56 Mouse donated for this and says there are so many RC Cola commercials.
Some people love cola so much they can't stop drinking it. And for them, there's RC. With RC, you get a great cola taste that's easy on the syrup, easy on the gas. So it doesn't feel like too much. Right, OJ? RC, a great cola taste that's easy on the syrup, easy on the gas. For people like O.J. Simpson, who can't stop drinking cola.
What a terrible commercial. I mean, besides the murderer. Obviously, the murderer thing is not great. But, like, hey, I know other sodas are bubbly and sweet, but RC Cola isn't. Like, what? That's not a selling point. Vince Omni donated for this one and says the Doritos commercial with a well-known YouTube icon. All right.
Pastor, we're losing our flock. We must find a way to get them back to church.
I know.
Please give me a sign.
Got it.
What? This isn't real.
Cool Ranch?
Other line.
Where's the Pepsi Max?
Over there.
This isn't real.
Max.
Wait, really? Just wait. What? Why was the angry video game nerd there? And that was like a fairly, that wasn't like young too, right? Just as, was this the era where like we put the internet thing in the commercial and that's the joke? Is that it? It's just, hey, we did it. It's the thing.
Maximum taste.
Ah, but zero calories.
More new parishioners.
Hey, FYF.
FYF?
Feed your flock.
Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Weird. That was genuinely weird. Torgo donated for this one and says resubmitting for Modern Bard. Oh, okay. Okay, I see what happened.
Honestly, I'm not really sure why I'm calling.
I'm having nightmares.
My husband and I, we're just fighting a lot.
I can't get any sleep.
Things just keep getting worse, and it's starting to feel like I can't do this by myself anymore.
We could use some help figuring things out.
Okay. Well, I'm glad you called. Why don't you tell me more about what's going on?
There's no wrong reason to reach out for crisis support. Whatever you're going through, the Veterans Crisis Line is here to help. Visit veteranscrisisline.net to learn more.
And immediately from that to Joey Wheeler. God, what a thing we do here. What just a conflagration of humanity. Oh boy, here we go. Here we go.
Got any fives?
No, go fish. Any sixes?
Welcome back to the International Go Fish Competition.
It's time to go fishing!
But why waste your time with kids' games when you could play the real McCoy?
That's right. There's something inside every duelist that drives them.
It's simply the best card game in town.
I know.
So why go fish when you can go Yu-Gi-Oh!
How about aces? You got any aces?
Exciting stuff.
Yu-Gi-Oh! Today at 5 in the zone!
Yu-Gi-Oh! No. Oh my god. Donut Disaster from Parker Brothers. I don't know if this is another mix-em-up, but Modern Bard says, a fun part of my... Oh, no, this is... Oh, they got it right. Amazing. MediaShare actually didn't get it confused. Modern Bard says, a fun part of my job is getting to see old board games forgotten to time in people's basements and seeing if there was a commercial for them. Saw this one today and just remembered to look it up. Is this actually fun? Is this fun or is this a plastic contraption that you will just want to play with outside of the game?
Oh, no.
lifting and shifting the donuts we bake. This crazy contraption is starting to shake.
Quiet, hurry up!
We've got to go faster. It looks like we're having a donut disaster!
It's donut disaster! The wacky
Gimba, if you want to know more about Yu-Gi-Oh, I have great news. There's an episode of Wizard and the Bruiser that will totally break it down for you.
Never know!
Will it glow?
I don't know!
We can't go any faster! Donut disaster!
Vasty donated for this and said, in case you were considering doing drugs. Oh no. Oh no, I'm scared.
Bad days don't stand a chance. Take the blade in your hands and...
God damn it. God damn it. Vasty, I'm sorry. Media Share, she's a cruel mistress. Let me get that commercial that you actually submitted for over on the YouTube window.
I'm Captain Lou Albano.
Oh, fuck. This one. God damn it. This one. Fuck.
About drugs, kids, don't be afraid to say no. Anyone that asks you to use drugs is not your friend. Drugs can and will kill. Remember, don't be afraid to turn to your priest, your rabbi, your minister, your moms, your dads, your teachers, because drugs can kill. And if you do drugs, you go to hell before you die.
God, is there a more incredible sentence than... if you do drugs, you go to hell before you die. God, it's... Thank you, Captain. Not even wearing the costume. Literally just shoving a Mario hat on his just normal-ass shirt. Just Mamma Mia, Mario Lou Albano. This is the kind of shit I'll have to... I'm going to be an old man having to explain that this was Mario to me. Who said that? The other there? Do the Mario, but not the crack.
You go to hell before you die.
Fill the crack inside the pipe, smoke it up in your lungs, do the Mario. God. Ugh. God. I never even bothered to copyright test the Super Mario Super Show. Because, it feels like Nintendo would just have, that shit on lockdown, you know? Anyway, here's hoping. Mellow Mushroom. Is this because we were talking about Homestar, and for a while the Homestar guys did the Mellow Mushroom website? Is that where this is coming from? Either way, I had Mellow Mushroom at a comedy festival in Asheville, North Carolina, and it was, insanely tasty. I was floored by just how good and pillowy and delicious a mellow mushroom pizza was.
If you're looking for a good time, there's a place that you should go. They serve pizza made with spring.
Who is this? Jason Marimarazna?
Water dough. Mellow mushroom for you and me. And take one bite and you'll see it will set your taste buds free. Mellow mushroom.
Stop.
I got that taste of goodness now. It's got a
what?
Hold of me.
I'm sorry, Daymok, did you... You're just casually dropping... Hi, I almost missed it, but explaining the birds and the bees to a 10-year-old. I hope it was your 10-year-old, or at the very least a 10-year-old that you should be explaining the birds and the bees to. It'd be weird if this happened on the bus. Ooh, Florella. Thank you for this. I was thinking about Perfection the game the other day. Flores says, hey kids, gather around and we'll play Anxiety the Game. Torgo, I haven't tested the Street Fighter show.
When you're into perfection, keep on your toes. You have to be quick, cause here's how it goes. Push the plunger down, set the timer.
This music is way more mellow than the 90s jingle. Mine not random. Oh, thank goodness, Daymok. I'm happy to hear it. The 90s one I remember is like, put the pieces into the clock, make the right connection, but be quick, erase the clock, pop! Like, that one was, like, upsetting. That one, like, captured the anxious energy of the game. This one makes it feel like a mellow good time.
Fit the pieces in place, don't be slow in perfection. You gotta move on fast, or the pieces pop up before you put in the last. And that's perfection.
Perfection, complete with playing box, mechanical timer, and 25.
You and Lover Boy, your struggle was mine as well. It was not a game for the kids who had to go to occupational therapy. Vasty donated for this and says, "Kukukuk crossover." Oh no!
Now in your kids' meal, toys from Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie. You and Yugi can unlock the secret of the puzzle and find a surprise dual monster inside. Let the battles begin. There are 20 dual monsters from Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie.
Damn.
One in every kid's meal, only in Burger
King. That's a lot of monsters. Oh my god. Gingerbeard, thank you for this one. Gingerbeard says, if you spun Snake around a lot in the camouflage menu, he would throw up as soon as you went back into the game. If you were poison, it would get rid of the status effect. See, that's the Kojima difference, goddammit. That attention to detail.
The critics agree. Metal Gear Solid 3 is a hit. 5 out of 5 from official PlayStation magazine. 5 out of 5 from GamePro magazine. 10 out of 10 and Game of the Year from PSM magazine. Snake is back. Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. Rated M for mature. From Konami.
Konami. R.I.P. Oh, no. Hey Reeves donated for this commercial. A drug PSA. Always a goddamn grab bag of horrors. Reeve says, I did in fact see the surgeon who took out my appendix in a dispensary. Wow.
Now, what's wrong with you? Tonsillitis?
Appendicitis?
Yeah! Nobody's died of tonsillitis around here for a while.
Appendicitis?
Nothing to worry about. Scalpel?
What if the joint were in somebody else's hand, like your surgeon, your lawyer, or your local policeman? Would you still say marijuana is harmless?
Yes.
No. Let's see if I can still make a straight line.
Jesus. Gingerbeard donated for another Ford Focus for part 2 or redo of the Ford Focus commercial with Metal Gear.
Colonel, long time no see.
Snake, today's briefing is of the utmost importance.
What is it, Colonel?
I'll be telling you all about the Ford Focus SE.
A Ford?
Yes, Snake. You should know, the Ford Focus SE comes with a standard rear-view camera. Plus, it has an EPA estimated 36 highway miles per gallon.
EPA estimated 36 highway miles per gallon? That's remarkable.
Yes, Snake. The Focus SE is the perfect vehicle for driving around Shadow Moses Island.
Colonel, let me stop you. I'm going to Fulton extract myself a Ford Focus SE right now.
But Snake, that technology hasn't been used since 1984. Snake. Snake. Snake!
Ah, I can see into your mind. So you're interested in a Ford Fusion Titanium?
Don't remember any of these.
You like its 2.0 liter EcoBoost engine, don't you? I can read you like an open book. You lack its secure cord keyless entry and optional power moonroof, I see. Still don't believe me. Your ears marvel at the audio system from Sony with 12 speakers. Perfect for listening to long codec calls. Stop hesitating, Snake. It's the perfect car for you.
I was doubtful until he mentioned the Sony sound system. And yeah, no, that level of like marketing brain for cross promotion would absolutely exist. Sinistro donated for this one. It's goddamn Zoo Books. Let's go back to a simpler time. We did bring up Zoo Books already.
Now your child can visit steamy jungles, grassy plains, and the dark depths of the oceans to meet and learn surprising facts about the magnificent animals that live there, all through the captivating, colorful pages of Zoo Books, the publication especially created for young readers. Each monthly issue of Zoo Books is packed with breathtaking, full-color photos.
You have to plug the car into the second controller port, goddammit.
Plus games and puzzles. Today, through this exclusive TV offer, you can get 12 fascinating issues of Zoo Books for the special price of
$19.95. Yak.
When you call
first time chatter, because the Zoo Books magic got him feeling too frisky.
Collection of animal stickers and the tiger poster. So order Zoo Books today and send learning and fun to a child you love.
I mean, they were kind of more magazine.
Zoo Books for 1995. Call 1-800-441-2400. When you call, we'll include the bonus elephant issue stickers and tiger poster with your order. Call 1-800-441-2400.
God damn it! No! No, you fuckers! We've been streaming for 3.5 hours and you pull this like now? No, fuck you! Fuck you! No! Oh, you got me! You got me! I was so weak and vulnerable! Oh, God! God damn it! God, Holden did that to me today. I literally, that already happened to me today, and then you do it too. Fuck, this is, you're established, this is such a dangerous precedent. God, you opened up Adobe Premiere and or Wondershare Filmora to do that. Or perhaps a pirated copy of Sony. There was, you, that, ah. Thank you, Sinescro. Thank you for that. Congratulations on 100%ing Binding of Isaac the other day. I'm very proud of you. We only have just the barest handful of commercials left. Torgo donated for this one and said, what's that? You wanted the bonkers ad again, but in French? I didn't ask for that. I didn't ask for that, but okay. What is this? What is this mystical elf language coming at me?
Bankers est surprenant, on dirait que c'est une bonne blague, parce que jouer une carte bankers fait changer les règles du jeu. Tu verras au jeu bankers, chaque fois que tu lances les dés, on dirait bien qu'au bankers, chaque tour a tout changé. Quand tu penses que tu gagnes, tout le monde est à tes trousses, et bankers de Parker Brothers soudain devient une course. Puis tu recules et repars, y'a du plaisir certain, et quand t'es sûr d'avoir perdu, tout d'un coup tu gagnes. Bankers c'est drôle, bankers amuse, bankers ça varie à tous les coups.
Bankers, un jeu de Parker Brothers.
Whatever. Donnie Lurch, boyfriend of the birthday girl Katie, donated for this one. And hey, Katie, it's still your birthday, and I'm still wishing you a happy one because your boyfriend Donnie donated to the stream.
Psst. Got what? Any dirty videos? Bet you haven't seen this. The Scotch Video Head Cleaner. It cleans up dirty pictures caused by dirty video recording heads. Oh, glory. Look at that bone structure.
What the fuck? The name head cleaning was already suggestive. Goddamn, sex sells. And the last commercial. Oh, no. Reeves is coming in. Reeves coming in hot at the last second. All right. All right. Let's see. Well, second to last, then, is Mutant Lover Boy donated for this one and says, you could catch this show in the mid-90s if you were a kid that stayed up till 2 a.m. and had neglectful parents, a very familiar host as well.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Jay Robinson, your host for Beyond Bizarre. The dictionary defines bizarre as an adjective, a word meaning deviating from the customary, conceived or done with no reference to reality or common sense.
We're going to take a journey together and shake up the orderly progression of your lives to the gray area between the rational and unexplained, where civilization and chaos are just a heartbeat away from each other.
If you can drop that, whatever
so
you submitted in
what you see
and
hear may be beyond your current experience. So let me be your guide to the bizarre and beyond.
Actual final thing of the night comes from Reeves, who says, the deepest core memory was getting these on VHS from the library as a kid.
Been on pins and needles lately? This weekend, invite all your friends.
Hey, wait for me.
You can just kick back or get totally wild.
Oh, video zoo books.
Watch two episodes of Amazing Animals back-to-back weekend mornings at 9, 8 central on Disney. You'll be happy as a clam.
All right. All right. God, we've been going for a while. Once again, thank you to the Secret Society over on YouTube for keeping the faith alive. I apologize that the chat box was still messed up. I will do what I can to fix it. I think it just means I got to log out of all my shit and log back in and hope that it works. Vasti, I'm glad you had fun tonight. I'm glad a lot of you had fun tonight. Let me just boot the music back. Well, we learned some things. We learned some things about mommies. We learned some things about daddies. We watched some weird commercials. We had some heartfelt moments, and we were also screaming in delight and agony. I hope on this crazy space adventure of life, you can be the Guzman we need. Mixic says in YouTube chat, y'all are the real ones. No, you are the real one. We are all real ones. Just going to go take a look over at Twitch and see if, is Amber still streaming? I saw she started, but we've been going for a while since then. No, Amber's streaming. All right, we're going to go raid Amber. No, everybody say hi. Tell him the puppet boy sent you. And until next time, be kind, don't be a jerk, and I will see all of you same dumpster time, same dumpster channel. Have fun, y'all. Have a good one. I will see you when I see you. I am going to... Oh, my God. I'm just going to pass the fuck out. I'm going to just collapse into a puddle. Starting the raid now. Ta-ta, y'all.
Oh. Gavin, cool.
And I'm still live on YouTube, aren't I?
It looks like,
Hi, YouTube people. I'll fix this shit, I promise. I swear. I'll talk to you soon.